Rogers Center in Philadelphia. It's time for New York Knicks basketball. Tonight, the Knickerbockers visit the Philadelphia 76ers. Second game of a back-to-back for the Knicks. Last night, they win at the buzzer, as described by Gus Johnson.
He's going to have to take it himself. Finds Thomas in the corner. Tim Thomas.
Another close game for the Knicks. They breathe a huge sigh of relief as they survive against the expansion Bobcats. But again, another one that goes down to the wire. Hello, everyone. Along with Walt, Clyde Frazier, Mike Breen on hand. Seems almost every game for the Knicks going down to the final minute and many times the final possession. This year, it's been unbelievable how many times that's happened, as right now the Knicks are tied for first in the NBA in games decided by 6 points or less. Last night, just another example. You see, the Knicks, though, have been on the wrong side in the majority of the games. Last year, it was a strength of the team. This year, the luck has not bounced their way often. Sometimes it's because of injury. Sometimes it's just because of poor execution down the stretch of these close games. Coach Herb Williams talked about some of the important things needed in the close games to get the win.
The one thing you have to do under pressure is always attack. The minute you stop attacking and then you get on your heels, you get tentative, so you don't take the first open shot. You may pass up that second open shot, but at the end, it's going to be tough. It's going to be tough because then the defense starts to squeeze you and you got the ball in the guy's hands and he has to go one-on-one. So you always have to attack. The first good shots you get, you probably got to take it.
Well, the Knicks certainly have a lot of experience this year in those close games. Clyde, for you, what are the most important ingredients in those close games to come out with victories?
Well, first of all, you need confidence. You got to believe. You have to have execution. And that's what the Knicks have been lacking in those games. They've had the lead ball, but they have not been able to finish. So I think when you lose so many close games, folks, you start thinking negatively, like, how are we going to lose this game, rather than positively, like, how are we going to win the game? So finally getting a break last night, which they needed. And so I think that's going to carry over into this game. So winning is contagious. So look for the Knicks to show a different composure tonight against the Sixers.
Meanwhile, one other Knick note, Jamal Crawford, who had 23 in the game last night, back in the starting lineup tonight against Philly. Now, here in Philadelphia, the 76ers and their fans still buzzing over what happened on Saturday when Allen Iverson exploded for a career-high 60 points. Clyde Iverson, he's going to be 30 by the end of this year. He's now in his ninth year, but he is still attacking the basket without any fear.
Yep, reckless abandon, invincible, indefensible these days is Allen Iverson. He's had two back-to-back 50-point games this season before the 60-point eruption. But what's amazing, folks, this man is listed as 6 feet. Maybe he's 5'10". And how fearless he is in going to the basket. He has all the offensive moves. He's led the league in scoring 3 times. He's been the MVP. So he's done it all. He has it all. Just lacking the championship right now. But Allen Iverson, obviously one of the candidates for MVP thus far this season. And he must be contained tonight, as he will be looking to erupt as well against Stephon. They always have a dramatic confrontation in the backcourt.
He received a lot of standing ovations on Saturday, which ironically was the first sellout of the season at home for the 76ers. And it was also the second game of a back-to-back. They played in Toronto the night before. And you see the free throws, 27 free throw attempts, which is his career high for a game. Meanwhile, he's got some help. Kyle Korver, the second-year swingman from Creighton, only behind Quentin Richardson in 3-point field goals made and attempted this year. He's becoming one of the best young shooters in the NBA from 3-point range. So it's the Knicks and Sixers' third meeting. Knicks have won twice already, including here in December when they overcame a 19-point fourth-quarter deficit. They'll try and make a 3 straight over the Sixers coming up. Starting lineups and opening tip when we return.
In 1876, my great-great-grandfather, Adolphus Busch, started brewing a handcrafted beer right here in St. Louis called Budweiser. And that recipe of ingredients is the same today as it was when it was founded over 125 years ago. I think tradition is a very, very important thing because there are certain values like quality and integrity that really should never change. Budweiser started as a great beer and is still that same great beer today.
To us. Please continue to hold.
All I want you to do for me, give it to me once again. Hello? Hi.
My life's about dancing to my own tune. My American Express card always backs me up.
Great job on that presentation today.
Thank you. See you tomorrow.
It's as driven as you are. The new redesigned Camry XLE. Now that's moving you forward.
I've put a lot of hard work into my home. Every day there's another thing that needs to be fixed, added onto, or updated. But one thing I've taken care of, how it's all paid for.
Call Champion Mortgage at 1-800-CHAMPION for customized home equity loans and refinancing solutions.
Hey, home equity loan and refinancing rates are still incredibly low. If you have a mortgage, a credit card, or any loan above this rate, call Champion Mortgage and save.
Don't miss out. Whatever your financial situation, call 1-800-CHAMPION before rates go up.
New York Knicks basketball is brought to you by Budweiser. Grab a cold, fresh Budweiser. It's game time. By Continental Airlines, official airline of the New York Knicks. Continental Airlines, work hard, fly right. By American Express, official card of the NBA. And by Jeep, trail-rated capability only in a Jeep 4x4.
Bill Daughtry at the MSG Sports Desk. After Monday's meetings with a federal mediator, the NHL and its Players Association are reportedly still talking. The two sides said to be meeting in an undisclosed location in a last-ditch effort to try and save their season. TSN and Canada also reporting tonight that Commissioner Gary Bettman and Union Chief Bob Goodenow were not at Sunday's meeting with the federal mediator. The NHL reportedly is scheduled a news conference for sometime on Wednesday. To a much more pleasant topic, Major League Baseball and some of those New York Yankees seen in Tampa today. Pitchers and catchers aren't due to report to Legends Field until tomorrow. But on Monday, several veterans working down the block at the minor league facility. Derek Jeter, returning Tino Martinez, Jorge Posada, and the new guy, Carl Pavano, all working out. And as you might expect, much of their comments focusing on the steroid situation. But Tino, he had some thoughts on his former teammate and now famous author, Jose Canseco.
I don't know Canseco that well. He played on our team for a little while, and what his situation is off the field right now. But I didn't think it was the right thing to do to a lot of guys he played with and tried to win games with. It's a tough thing for them to deal with now. The guys, just names that are mentioned, whether they're guilty or not, are going to have to answer questions in spring training and always have doubts as well.
Jeff Garcia is looking for a job. He was released Monday by the Cleveland Browns. The team cutting ties to the three-time Pro Bowl quarterback after one season and with 3 years left on his contract. Garcia signed a four-year, $25 million free agent deal with the Browns just last March after spending five seasons with the San Francisco 49ers. A compelling story later on tonight on Sports Desk. Hofstra wrestling coach Tom Ryan has built the Pride into a force to be reckoned with nationally while enduring a personal situation that would be difficult, if not impossible, for any of us to bear. One of the more compelling reasons to watch Sports Desk tonight after Knicks basketball.
First day. Nervous? Want me to drop you off here so you can walk up?
No, you can pour it up.
Sure you're going to be all right?
Should be.
Bye, honey.
What's up?
Nice ride.
Just stick with me, kid. I know this town like the back of my hand. Hey, that's new.
From the creators of Ice Age, they're well built.
Oh, dear.
I'll get them.
Oh, look at that. Oh, now they're arm wrestling.
Well maintained.
This is my third oil change today. Something's wrong with me.
And they're fighting back.
We're here to save you! How do you think it's going so far?
Robots.
Who are these losers?
We, sir.
I'm a woman. Ouch.
Rated PG. March 11th, only in theaters.
Right now, we have to get to our traffic report. Let's do that. How about that traffic report?
Traffic is horrible this morning. I get the feeling.
People are trying to get to work this morning.
Speaking of introducing the Acura RL with the first real-time traffic monitoring system through AcuraLink. It can help you find an open road
And with 300 horsepower and the world's most advanced all-wheel drive, it knows what to do when it gets there.
We're really trying to get you to track.
Oh, you know what? My mother Ford's going to take that in.
The all-new Acura RL.
President Celebration event at your Chrysler dealer, where for a limited time, get a great deal on Chrysler Pacifica with a 5-star frontal crash test rating, including 0+, 0% financing plus $2,500 in bonus cash. Or qualified buyers can get a 2005 Pacifica Touring all-wheel drive for $299 a month for 39 months. This President Celebration event ends February 28th, so visit your Chrysler dealer today.
Back at the Wachovia Center in Philadelphia, where the Knicks had one of their more stirring comebacks. 19 down in the fourth, came back and beat the Sixers in December. There's their starting lineup. Corliss Williamson starting. Kenny Thomas, by the way, is out with a back problem. He's not playing. Samuel Dellenberg with Kyle Korver, Iverson, and the rookie, Andre Iguodala, starting for Jim O'Brien. And for the Knicks, Nazi Muhammad in the starting lineup, despite the strained groin, with Tim and Kurt Thomas, Marbury and Crawford for Herb Williams. And Clyde, lots of times players get banged up, especially when your team's in a rough stretch in a losing situation. And lots of times the mindset, I'm going to sit down and rest, wait till this get better. In a lot of ways, Nazi Muhammad should not be playing. This strained groin has him severely limited, but he is doing everything he can to play in the last several games. He says he'll get his rest during the All-Star break. And the quote that he said was, you can either sit or fight. And the way our team's playing right now, I want to fight. And he's out there playing despite not being or being far from 100%.
Well, Nazi has the heart of a champion, two NCAA championships at Kentucky, so he knows all about winning. Also understands adversity and realizing now the team is on a lot of adversity, so he has to be out there to try to propel them.
Yeah, the last couple of games when he's out, he's riding a stationary bike. As Bob Delaney, the crew chief, with Tony Brothers and Jason Phillips. We're set to go. Samuel Dellenberg, a former Seton Hall product. And Muhammad at center.
And that might not be a good sign, folks. You saw Muhammad did not jump right there. So Dellenberg, no problem with the tap.
Thomas on the rookie, Iguodala. There's Korver. Crawford's going to have to play up on him tonight because Korver's got terrific range. Iverson quickly in the paint and already his first bucket.
And you saw Iverson using the left hand with the scoop.
Coming off that 60-point explosion against Orlando.
And Stephon has also been on an offensive spree, scoring spree as well.
Marbury gets inside himself.
And he with the left hand but misfired.
Now, he just would have laid it in, but he kind of tried a little flip shot. And that put too much spin on the ball. There's Korver, and there's the three. And Tip Thomas the rebound. 76ers have been scoring a lot of points this year. Getting over the 100-point mark quite a bit. In fact, 24 times this year they've been over 100 points. Last year they only did it 11 times the whole season. So Jim O'Brien has them looking to push the ball more. That's a three from Thomas.
That's a little deja vu.
This one does not get the fortunate bounce. What was amazing about that play, Clyde, is Iverson lost the ball. Good help defense from Kurt Thomas. Was the crowd reaction when it first went up in the air. Oh, and then all of a sudden they cheer when it comes down. Marbury kicks it out, and Thomas knocks down the two-pointer.
So you mentioned the high scoring. The Sixers, most teams that score a lot, they also give up a lot of points. So the Knicks can score on them as well.
Iverson just walked it across the half-court mark. He was at the seven-second point. It's an eight-second violation. He's upset. He felt he got hit on the left hand last time down the floor. Kurt Thomas with the block shot.
And he averages one per game, does Kurt. Speed on speed, Stephon along the sideline.
Crawford for three. And Jamal Crawford knocks down the three-pointer. And the Knicks with a 5-2 lead.
And that's a good sign for Crawford early on. He still has the confidence that he had last night with a good shooting performance.
Iverson's mad already. He felt Marbury pushed him off on that last play, and he felt he was fouled. Williamson goes, stripped by Kurt Thomas. Williamson gets it back, and there's a foul. Thomas had two steals and a block. Well, that time Williamson recovered nicely.
What a fortuitous bounce as Kurt stripped the ball. Williamson going to the basket, it bounced right back to him. Watch the luck of Williamson. There's the strip, and then he comes right down. There's the ball. Kurt in the air, and he's charged with the foul.
So Corliss Williamson in his first year with Philly. Last year won a championship with Detroit. And he was very upset when he was traded. Traded in the Derek Coleman deal. Said at first extremely mad. He liked where he was, but he's really turned things around in terms of his mental approach. Says he loves his new teammates, loves it here in Philly, and is enjoying playing in Philly.
And to me, the Sixers and the Pistons are not as good a team as without he and Okur. That's why I think the Pistons are having their troubles this season.
Yep, they miss Mike James as well. Meanwhile, Herb Williams just called over to Allen Iverson, I think just to congratulate him on a 60-point game. And Williamson knocking down a free throw. That's just a couple of seconds ago. Falling out. Nice display of sportsmanship. Herb Williams knows how difficult it is to score 60 in a game. Iguodala, a very good defensive player, is on Crawford. He's got good size as well. Crawford, a little shake and bake move.
Also, Mike, there are not a lot of coaches that would have done just what Herb did. Guy has no ego.
Absolutely, Clyde.
that's indicative of folks. Most coaches would not do that.
Williamson can't connect. D'Alembert lost it. And Crawford trying to track it, but throws it right to Williamson. And then Williamson puts it in.
Ill-advised play by Crawford. You like the hustle, but not the pass to make in that scenario.
You know what I know about Herb Williams, Clyde. Didn't have an ego as a player. Just a real pro in every way he's approached the game. As a player, as an assistant coach, and now as a head coach.
Sixers with good intensity on the defense now.
Kurt Thomas left open. And Muhammad can't get the rebound. Corver tracks it down. Puts it right into the hands of Iverson, who has moved back to the point guard spot this year by Jim O'Brien. Drives underneath, scoop layup, can't go. And Nazi Muhammad the rebound.
More complaints by Iverson. That time just missed an easy opportunity.
He's yelling at Tony Brothers on the way down the floor.
Good dishing here by the Knicks and the swish by Kurt.
Talk about a delayed trailer play.
So the Knicks seem to be up for the task. Very cohesive on the offense.
I think. When you play Iverson, as he just blows by. Kurt Thomas upset. He's coming out to talk about Jason Phillips. That's going to be his second foul. He's going to have to come out of the game.
And Williamson just hurt his back, so he's coming out of the game. Very pugnacious Iverson now. And this was a good dishing by the Knicks. Right here to Kurt Thomas, 20 feet away, right at the top of the key.
Kurt Thomas didn't like that call, but he clearly pushed off on that play. Don't know if anything happened before that he was complaining about. And Mark Jackson in the game. Jackson steps back. Not a good shot. And Nazi Muhammad able to corral the rebound.
Obviously, whenever Kurt leaves the game, it's a tremendous loss for the Knicks because of his versatility.
Mainly for his defense. Muhammad, just inside, tried to force it. Sweetney's in for Kurt Thomas. And Sweetney hammered. And he'll go to the free throw line once again, which is what he does best, as Mark Jackson called for the foul. Nope, they call it on Korver, excuse me. There you see Sweetney. The free throws last couple of games, 18 times. Now you look, 9 free throw attempts for 48 minutes. Of all the bench players in the NBA, he gets to the line the fourth most in terms of frequency. Obviously, he doesn't play big minutes, so he's not amongst the NBA leaders. But in terms of per 48 minutes, if he received more playing time, he'd be amongst the leaders in free throw attempted.
Yep, he thrives in the paint. Really asserts himself underneath.
Of course, free throw shooting has been a roller coaster ride lately for the Knicks. It helped win the game last night when they were 26 of 28. They had struggled in some prior games as Iverson shot won't go. Tim Thomas the rebound. Nice quick outlet. The Sixers are back on D. Crawford, good hard drive, can't finish. Muhammad keeps it alive. Last touch by Iverson. It should be Nick Ball, and it is.
Iverson having a rough night. Got hit in the face by D'Alembert that time. And Crawford in a hurry. Knowing that he can elude Carver, misfires, though, and there's the collision by Iverson and his teammate. The Knicks have it underneath.
He's upset. He felt he was fouled, but as you said, Clyde, it was his own teammate that did that, and a moving pick on Sweetney.
Chronic problems for Sweetney. Kurt Thomas moving screens. Must be stationary on that play, so he's charged with his first foul.
So the Knicks with their second team foul. So that one doesn't count as a team foul. First on Sweetney, but they have two. The Sixers have one. Played about 5 minutes.
Iverson very offensive minded.
And he stepped out of bounds.
Iverson turnover prone, folks. Remember one game against the Knicks, he had 9 turnovers.
For the season, he's averaging just under 4. So that's about a norm for him. Guy handles the ball.
You go with 7 assists.
Yeah. He's in the top 10 in assists and scoring. That doesn't happen very often, although 3 guys are in that this year. Marbury, nice move inside. And a soft floater. The other two are LeBron James and Dwayne Wade, but that's a rarity. Marbury did it once in his career. Gary Payton. He'd be in the top 10 in scoring and assists.
Post up Jamal!
Korver looking to post up Crawford.
Not his forte. Too close.
As you can see by that shot.
He's 6'7", but just practicing the three-point shot.
His strength is facing the basket, spotting up for threes. Iverson goes for the steal. Marbury gets inside. It's been a physical start. Sweetney knocks it down.
Sweetney improving facing the basket, folks. He's obviously more comfortable with his back to the basket, but now thriving facing the basket.
Poor transition defense. It's very difficult to guard Allen Iverson, but Stephon Marbury has to make him work harder than that.
Yep, Steph is looking for help. There's no help coming.
Thomas for 3. And Tim Thomas knocks it down. Knicks 2 of 3 from downtown.
Somewhat of a homecoming for Tim. Played collegially at Villanova. One season there before turning pro.
Jim O'Brien not happy with the start for his team defensively. As the Knicks open up shooting 54% from the field. And Tim Thomas showing some life here in the first quarter.
Yeah, Stephon breaking down the defense. Tim the recipient from downtown.
High school hoops fans, catch tomorrow's superstars today. Get the complete Tri-State Rundown with Mike Quick and Max Preps High School Weekly, only on MSG Network.
I feel I'm entitled to inadequate computer virus protection.
I'd like a virus that makes my computer freeze up like a banana daiquiri.
Incomplete virus protection totally rocks.
Millions of Americans are just asking for a computer virus because they're not nearly as protected as they think they are.
My computer's only half protected. And I live for danger.
That's why America Online now gives our members virus protection that works for your whole computer, not just email. Absolutely free.
That's nice.
Want a better internet? You belong at America Online.
I love you. Meet me tomorrow in the park.
Matthew's girlfriend disappeared.
She wouldn't have left without an explanation.
And the stranger he's discovered.
My friend Elisa's.
I'm Lisa.
Will take him down a dangerous path.
She had the same name. It's so creepy.
You don't know the whole story.
What are you doing here?
Watching me sleep.
Discover where obsession leads.
Love makes you do crazy things.
Josh Hartnett, Wicker Park.
Tune to channel 125 and above and order it with your remote on DirecTV pay-per-view.
Game's on.
Just listen to your Dell, man.
The let me just see the remote. That's not.
Get the silver key.
Wow, that was the shot of the game.
Oh, that's just great. Now is the perfect time to get great Dell gear, like this Dell HD Plasma TV for just $31.99 after $300 mail-in rebate. Plus, get a free Samsung DVD player. Dell Pocket DJs are just $199. Plus, get free shipping and lots of other great Dell deals. Just call or go online now. Get more out of now.
Work.
Atlantic Pack ticket plans now available for prices starting at $160. See the Knicks take on the division rivals. Get free food, free gear, free Knicks yearbook, and an autograph from John Starks. Call the Knicks season subscription department right now at 877-NYK. They're just playing Barry White on the speaker, Clyde. It's the only arena in the NBA that plays Barry White. That's why you love it down here. Iverson, shot won't go. Defended well. Sweetney, quick outlet. Marbury now with Iguodala on him. And Iguodala is going to be a good defender. Crawford tried to force it.
Iverson releases. They have numbers.
Alley-oop goes. And the rookie with the finish. The kid from Arizona is 21 years old. Gets a nice feed from Iverson.
Yeah, Iguodala, 2 seasons he's played at Arizona before turning pro. and started the season right away, so he has good potential.
Thomas against Korver. Thomas can post up. We've seen him that time in and out. And Samuel D'Alembert the rebound.
Sixers getting a little momentum now.
So playing D'Alembert and Jackson at the same time, you don't really see that. Iverson stripped again. He's furious again. He's arguing almost every call. Crawford, nice feed. And Marbury with the finish.
And a good push by Crawford. Very speedy backcourt combination that time, paying off for Stephon.
The Knicks down by eight. Knicks have done a good job. They're playing Iverson in a physical way, and the refs are letting him call it. Jackson knocks it down. You know, Clyde, we talk about the officiating crew. Bob Delaney's the crew chief, and he's the veteran. He's a guy that's been around a long time and sets the tone. It's in his 18th year. He's one of those officials that lets them play a lot more than others, and as a player, you need to adjust to that.
Yep, because the whistle, if it's a quick whistle, you have to lay off. And as you mentioned now, there can be a little more physical. Iverson not liking it, though.
Thomas can't connect. Knicks down. Knicks with a six-point lead. Iverson, quick move. Shot won't go. Tipped up and in. They give it to Iverson. Apparently, it wasn't tipped.
And good thing that it wasn't. It would have been a goaltend by Jackson, so he laid off at the right time.
And a technical foul. He's been arguing right from the opening tip. And he's still yelling at Bob Delaney. Delaney also, not only is he one of the better officials and lets guys play, but he also does not take a lot of stuff from players. And Iverson has to be careful. Mark Jackson, you see, trying to stay in between Delaney and Iverson. That's a smart move from Jackson.
I would not like to see Iverson thrown out of the game tonight. There'd be a riot in this place.
Coming off a 60-point game, Marbury misses.
Let's see why Iverson is so pugnacious. Right there, he thought he was fouled, and this manifested into a hoop for Stephon in transition. So Iverson showing his disdain for the lack of calls now.
An official, you get your second technical, you automatically throw it. An official can throw you out on the first technical if he deems it's unsportsmanlike enough. Meanwhile, Sixers back within four.
Now Iverson tightening up his D on Stephon.
Good help defense from D'Alembert. Crawford on the drive, stripped to the ball. Sweetney across the lane. Nice up and under move from Sweetney, but he can't finish. Jerome Williams with a rebound.
Warriors are everywhere tonight.
Williams played with Iverson for a couple of years. That's not the shot he normally takes. Although he had one of his best games of the season here, Clyde, when the Knicks came back. Williams was the key as Sweetney picks up his second foul.
Iverson is just gung-ho right now, going to make the challenge the officials to make calls against the Knicks. Every time down, he's penetrating inside.
He's even arguing this call because he felt it should have been in the act of shooting.
See, right now he's forcing the action, trying to anticipate calls, and he gets this one, but it's none shooting.
Now, he obviously threw it up at the basket after he felt the contact. Nice move that time.
At the top of the show, we feature Iverson and his tenacity for a man that's perhaps 5'10". Look at the aggression that he attacks the basket.
He's certainly one of the toughest players I've ever seen play in this league. Marbury, nice move inside.
Stephon, of course, renowned for his physical play as well, but he's 6'2", 185. Iverson's just maybe 5'11", 165.
Two point guards who can take the ball to the basket as well as anybody in the league. Iguodala.
Jackson, a good perimeter shooter at 6'10".
That's a little further out than he normally shoots. And here's a guy who was born and raised in Philly, went to Roman Catholic High School. And always said it was a dream for him to come and play in Philadelphia. This is his second year. Last year he was banged up almost the entire season. Marbury, and a reaching foul on D'Alembert. Sixers continue to argue.
And Stephon continues to break down their defense, getting tangible results.
The New York Knicks look better than ever in high definition on MSG Network powered by Panasonic. See the crystal clear difference of Knicks basketball and HDTV. The difference is widescreen coverage of all the dazzling game action. The sharpest images, along with Dolby Digital Sound. See more of the game like you've never seen it before. Join the high-def revolution for a breathtaking home viewing experience. The Knicks on MSG Network in stunning high definition. Available on IO Digital Cable Service from Cablevision.
Right now, we have to get to our traffic report. Let's do that. How about that traffic report?
Traffic is horrible this morning. I get the feeling.
People are trying to get to work this morning.
Speaking of introducing the Acura RL with the first real-time traffic monitoring system through AcuraLink. It can help you find an open road. And with 300 horsepower and the world's most advanced all-wheel drive, it knows what to do when it gets there.
We're really trying to get you the traffic.
Oh, you know what? My mother forced me to take that in.
The all-new Acura RL.
Back in Philadelphia, she has her Valentine's Day outfit on. As we remind you, Anheuser-Busch salutes parents who talk to their kids about drinking. Responsibility matters. 2:06 left in the first. Knicks up two. Remember, Knicks came back from 19 down in the fourth quarter last time they played here, mainly because of Jerome Williams.
And the Junkyard Dog, renowned for his hustle. Right there, showing his stuff. Harassing defense, coming up with steals. Always effervescent going to the glass along the baseline with the nasty stuff.
Williams was superb that night in leading that comeback. He was the 13 points, 9 rebounds, and the 4 steals. Just so much energy he brought. Shot clock down to 7. Tim Thomas.
We're looking to exploit Carver, but he did a good job that time.
Crawford. Yeah, that's not a great shot in that possession. Knicks with a 2-point lead. Reach and foul. Marbury picks it up. No, first on Marbury.
Knicks' biggest lead has been 8 points. So Iverson has been complaining early on in the game for a lack of calls by the official. Has a technical.
Penny Hardaway, who was not feeling well earlier today. Kind of a stomach bug, checks in. And Crawford sits down. Crawford 1 of 4 to start.
Hardaway has been extraordinary with his shooting since returning from his injury. He's very accurate with the jumper.
Iverson, oh, what a beautiful move. Split two defenders, up and in.
Yeah, Matador D that time by the Knicks, just waving at him.
Again, he's as tough as anybody to keep in front of you. But you have to make it difficult for him. Marbury inside of Vin Baker. Thomas spots up and can't hit the three.
Iverson needs help. Again, he slices between a couple of Knicks.
D'Alembert comes up short, and Jerome Williams, they say, pushed off. And Williams will pick up the foul.
The Knicks will pay for their transgressions as they are in the penalty now.
Trevor Ariza comes in for Tim Thomas.
Let's take a look at Williams. Right there, very subtle, but they got him with the push in the back, so Jackson's at the line.
Jackson was smart. A little overly dramatic on what was a mile push, but a push nonetheless. That's why he's at the line. Jackson hits it. Well, American Express Atlantic Division standings. Sixers now just a half game back of the Celtics. Philly has a pretty good schedule the rest of the way. Meanwhile, the Knicks still in last place in this Atlantic Division. But again, because of the way the division is,
three wins, you could be in first.
Right, three wins, and you're right back in the thick of it. They're 5.5 out. And the players keep telling themselves that even though the record is poor, they've gone through a brutal stretch, that they still have to play for a chance to get in the playoffs. Philly, meanwhile, on a 12-2 run, as Hardaway knocks down the jumper. And good, something's wrong with the shot clock.
Good continuity by the Knicks continue, albeit they have an eclectic group of Knicks in the game now, but efficiency still remains.
Knicks with 7 assists on their 9 field goals.
See, Iverson is also tireless. He averages 42 minutes a game. And right now, the point guard requires a lot of energy bringing the ball up the court, which he's been doing.
Second in the NBA in that department. A little fake.
Yeah, good help that time. 3 Knicks smothering him to force the turnover.
He moved his pivot foot. See, that was... Now, he does shoot a lot, but that was when we had 4 Knicks around him. He still shot the ball.
See right there, they all started helping out. Obviously, the coach had told them to focus on Iverson.
Three Knicks around, now four. Ariza gets in there. For the reason not coming off the bench. Good feet inside. Pretty pass from Hardaway. And Marbury now with 8 points.
Iverson, among the leaders in steals, sometimes he loses his man looking to make a steal. So that time, Stephon was open.
He's third in the NBA in steals, although spoke with Dick Carter, the assistant coach and the defensive guru. He said Iverson has really made some nice strides defensively this year. Nice feet inside again. Iverson just beating the Knicks off the dribble time and time again. Shot clock turned off. Ariza, Jerome Williams just gets it off the time, blocked by Delabere. And that will end the first quarter.
Delabere, their intimidator at 6'11". So that time denying the junkyard dog on his opportunity along the baseline.
I really can't stay.
Baby, it's cold outside.
I've got to go away.
Baby, it's cold out there.
This evening has been
hoping that you
so
drop
very
in.
Nice.
I'm thinking my hands, they're cold inside.
I ought to say no, no, no,
I'm
sir. At least I'm gonna say that I tried.
What's the sense of hurting my pride?
I really can't stay.
Now there's something to relieve stress, put a little strut in your step, and add years to your life. It will improve your outlook and where you look out to. It's the New York Lottery. Side effects include incredible happiness, a constant feeling of well-being, and an increased desire to jump up and down shouting, hooray, hooray. Ask your accountant if more money is right for you. Do not operate heavy machinery. Have someone do it for you. So play the New York Lottery. You won't feel like your old self again.
All shave gels are full of soap, and soap can leave your skin dry and irritated. Introducing Gillette Complete Multi-Gel, the only shave gel without soap, so you get healthy-looking skin. This is more than shave gel. This is skincare for a man. Gillette Complete Multi-Gel.
Introducing the all-new compact Mercury Mariner with intelligent four-wheel drive and V6 power. Mariner is everything you want in an SUV, only condensed. The smartly equipped Mercury Mariner starts at an introductory price under $22,000.
Derek Knicks basketball brought to you by New York Lottery. You can't live the dream if you don't play the game. Get your lottery ticket today. By Canon Business Solutions, your source for document management. And by your New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut Lexus dealer, who invite you to test drive a Lexus today. Second quarter set to begin. Knicks and Sixers tied at 23. Harlem Globetrotters returning to the Garden this Friday to perform the world's greatest basketball show. See all the trick shots and the comedy. For great seats, visit the Garden box office or call Ticketmaster. The Knicks jumped out to an 8-point lead. The Sixers led by Allen Iverson bouncing back. Iverson with 10 to lead Philly. Marbury with 8 to lead the Knicks.
The Nick bench must be instrumental tonight. Obviously, the Knicks played last night, so the bench must step up and give the starters a rest.
Aaron McKee and Brian Skinner come in for the first time for the Sixers. Marbury.
Ooh.
Oh, not even close. An air ball by about a foot.
Yep, he was only shooting because he was open, never really focused on the shot.
The tendency, especially if you're a scorer, a scoring point guard, when you play Iverson, is try to match him. And sometimes a good defense against him is to make him work at the other end of the floor. But you also have to take your shots in the flow.
Jackson duping baseline.
Nice move from Jackson off the dribble.
Yeah, he's a big dude, 6'10", 255. He's had a lethal touch since being inserted into the game.
He's got 10 points already. He's only played 9 minutes. Baker double team. Finds Ariza. I don't know where he saw him from there. Ariza almost had it blocked. Still got a shot off and Skinner the rebound.
Trevor has to take the 6-foot shot. He was open. Looking to penetrate closer.
Skinner just got off the injured list. Nice backup player for them.
Look out.
Iguodala scores.
Saw the Knicks standing there. No one got in his way.
So a big turnaround after the Knicks were up by 8. 12-point turnaround. They trail by 4. Marbury kicks it out.
shut down the paint, but the perimeter shots are there. The Knicks have to look for them.
And an offensive foul call against Vin Baker, pushed off. Good defense for Brian Skinner. Baker picks up his first.
And McKee's in there, too. McKee's also a good defender. So what the Sixers are doing now, folks, shutting down the paint area, forcing the Knicks to the perimeter. So the Knicks are still forcing the ball inside. They must take the baby jumpers on the perimeter.
Baker sits. Kurt Thomas, who picked up two quick fouls and sat down after 5 minutes, he's back in.
Conversely, on this end, the Knicks must shore up their defense. Iverson continues to penetrate inside.
Three seconds.
There he goes again. Baseline breaking down the deep.
Inside, Skinner can't hit it. Tip won't go. Fight for it. And Jerome Williams comes out of the pack. Kurt Thomas drills the jumper. Kurt Thomas' second field goal.
Yeah, Kurt had two quick fouls, folks, in the first quarter, relegated to the bench. So they missed his mid-range jumper, which has become a lost art in today's NBA game.
Skinner poked away and picked up by Hardaway. Nice play, Jerome Williams. He made the initial deflection, and Marbury gets inside.
Yeah, that was a little tenacity on the defense. Williams with the good hands.
And they're going to call a blocking foul. Very close to a travel that time on Iverson. Except Hardaway picks up the foul. That's his first.
At the last minute, Penny moved, and he was not stationary. Watch at the last moment, he's going to move. See right there into Iverson's way. That's why he's charged with the foul.
I pick.
Iverson gets in the paint again and puts it in. Iverson getting in the paint without any problem whatsoever.
See, and they've taken that away from Stephon. Watch this. See, they're triple teaming him, but he still makes the shot.
Marbury doing the same thing. He's getting in the paint without any problem. Both point guards doing a great job offensively, but neither stopping each other. And there's a kick. Is it a foul kick? It's going to be Kurt Thomas's third foul, and he's hot. So he's going to have to sit down probably for the rest of the half. Well, he's hot initially. He's got a smile on his face. It's more of that frustration smile. So Tip Thomas back in.
Kershaw, they don't like me. Let's see. Well, it shouldn't have been a foul. He was just faking it.
And Iverson kind of forced the contact on that time. That was not a kick.
Right. Back door.
And Marbury got a piece of the arm.
Steph has to see the ball and see his man simultaneously. And that time he only saw Iverson, and then the backdoor play was able to work along the baseline.
So Iverson to the free throw line. He took 27 in the game on Saturday. You see Tracy McGrady leading the NBA in minutes played. Iverson, former Celtic Antoine Walker. Now of course, with Atlanta. And Marbury, sixth right now in the league.
So not an aberration for Iverson. Perennially, he's among the leaders in minutes played.
Now, this year, shooting-wise, as Josh Davis comes into the game, Iverson shooting 41% from the field. He's 29% from three and 82% from the free throw line.
But also averaging 7 assists, 4 rebounds, and 2 steals. So not just an offensive threat, a very versatile player.
In the defense, he's always been a gambler. It's one of the reasons he's been on the top of the steals. He's never been a very good defender. Although, as I said, Dick Carter said he's really tried to improve.
See, the Sixers in some of a zone now, packing it into the paint, forcing the Knicks to the perimeter.
Ariza comes up short. Knicks down by a point. Iverson again. Inside and a foul.
To show you, when you're a superstar in this league, folks, Iverson was complaining early on, got a technical. Now he's starting to get calls. I thought that was a questionable call. The one on Kurt Thomas I thought was questionable as well. Let's take a look at this one. You make the call.
Wednesday on MSG, Stephon Marbury and the Knicks are back at the Garden to take on Michael Redd and the Bucks. The Knicks and the Bucks, Wednesday night, only on MSG Network.
Want to beat athlete's foot? Let's try a little one-on-one. Lamisil AT versus Lotrimin AF. Use this, you have to use it for 4 weeks. 4 weeks.
With Lamisil AT, 1 week and you're done.
That's four times faster. Lamisil AT, advanced treatment.
I love the way you've decorated in here.
Want to get away? Now you can. Fly on Southwest Airlines with our $39 to $149 internet specials to 59 destinations nationwide.
You are now free to move about the country.
That was not a foul.
That's number four on.
Come on.
This stuff tastes funny.
In the net, 17 for Turnaround jump shot. He counters with a...
With up to 40 NBA games a week, new stats and highlights, NBA League Pass from DirecTV is heaven. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS today.
Want to beat athlete's foot? Let's try a little one-on-one. Lamisil AT versus Lotrimin AF. Use this, you have to use it for 4 weeks.
4 weeks?
With Lamisil AT, 1 week and you're done.
That's four times faster. Lamisil AT, advanced treatment.
Fans, come join the team for Knicks Ball presented by Panasonic on March 10th at the Chelsea Piers. Test your bowling skills against the entire team while joining the Knicks coaching staff and a host of celebrities. All money raised benefits the Knicks Cheering for Children Foundation. Call the Knicks fan line for more information at 877-NYK-DUNK or log on to NewYorkKnicks.com. Iverson will go to the free throw line with just about 2.5 gone by here in the second. Here's our trivia question. Okay. The fifth guard in NBA history to score 60 points in a game. Who were the other four? We'll have the answer in a little bit. Good question, Clyde.
Well, I know one other, Pete Maravich. Michael Jordan.
Those two are the easy ones.
Let's see if the Big O ever hit 60 or Jerry West.
I'm sure you remember the Pete Maravich game.
Yeah.
That was against the Knicks. Ariza misfires, but you weren't guarding him at all that game, were you?
Some of it.
Iverson tied up. Nice feed, Iguodala. Davis got it. And Jackson tips it in, and the Sixers now up by six.
Very vivacious play on the interior by the Sixers. Now watch their defense, folks. Somewhat of a zone. They're going to pack it into the paint. See, there it is. Everybody's in the paint area. There's the perimeter shots available.
So Williams can't hit, and the Knicks have gone cold.
So with Williams in there and Ariza, they have given them that perimeter shot.
And a bad foul by Ariza, and the Knicks in the penalty with 7:41 remaining as Ariza picks up his first.
And Iverson, a frequent visitor to the line, will go back.
Oh, I just received word. Corliss Williamson most likely will not return. Back spasms. So yeah. His return is questionable. You saw him go out. They're already without Kenny Thomas, so Jim O'Brien shorthanded in the front court.
I saw Glenn Big Dog Robinson coming out, and he's saying he might be back next week. So he's been out most of the season as well.
Well, they really haven't wanted him to play. Robinson didn't want to be here. Jim O'Brien didn't care for his attitude. They've looked to trade him. As Iverson hits the free throw, Jim O'Brien, in his first year here in Philadelphia, is where he grew up, played his high school, his college ball.
Was once voted the best high school basketball player in Philly.
O'Brien. Sweetney inside. Can't get it to go in, and Davis the rebound.
Knicks have gone cold. Alley-oop to Iguodala.
Oh, beautiful pass. And Iguodala slams it through, and the Knicks are down 10.
Second time Iguodala has shown his stuff.
A 10-0 run. Ariza gets inside. Knicks taking it to the basket nicely as Ariza able to put it in. But not getting to the free throw line, only three free throw attempts.
But the Sixers want them to penetrate to the baskets. That's where all the congestion is. They're packing it into the paint.
Iverson fouled. They call the foul on Crawford. The Knicks a little frustrated now as they feel Iverson's now getting the benefit of the calls.
Let's take a look at Iguodala, 6'7", 210 pounds of fury in transition. Give Iverson the assist. We mentioned Iverson has had consecutive 50-point outings this season, folks. And in one three-game stretch, he had 54, 51, and 40 points.
Well, he's hit the 50-point mark now 9 times in his career, and that 60 was his career high.
Yeah, only he and Wilt Chamberlain have ever scored 60 as a Sixer in a regular season game.
10-point lead for Philly with 6.5 to play here in the second. And the Sixers really swarming defensively, playing like there's 6 guys out there.
See, that shot's there. The Knicks have the cannon. They can't make the 15-footer.
Oh, Thomas with a very difficult tip. Tip Thomas with 7 points. Iverson. Oh, he put that in. They're going to credit Mark Jackson, but it looked like Sweeney touched it.
Yeah, 2 extraordinary tip-ins. One by Thomas and then that one.
At the midway point of the second, Knicks with a quick start. But Philadelphia has bounced back nicely in a defensive 3 seconds against Philly. So a technical foul, and 1 shot. Mark Jackson, you see, has had a huge impact.
Take a look at the tap-in. It's hard to tell, but Jackson the closest Sixer, so he will receive the credit.
Just past the midway point of the second. Knicks down by double figures. Mark Jackson, 14 points off the bench.
Presenting the new Infiniti G35, available with intelligent all-wheel drive that automatically changes when conditions change. The new G35 from Infiniti.
Wednesday on MSG, the Knicks do a little big game hunting when Stephon Marbury and New York are back at the Garden to take on Michael Redd and the Milwaukee Bucks. The Knicks are the Bucks after game night, Wednesday night, only on MSG Network. Thursday on MSG, catch another Rangers Classic. It's April 9th, 1986, and Game 1 of the Patrick Division Semis with the hated Flyers. A 6-2 win gives the Blue Shirts a 1-game lead. Rangers Classics presented by Panasonic, Thursday night on MSG.
It's the President's Celebration event at your Chrysler dealer, where for a limited time, get a great deal on Chrysler Town & Country with stow-and-go seating and storage, including 0+, 0% financing, plus $2,500 in combined bonus cash. Or qualified buyers can get a 2005 Town & Country Touring for $299 a month for 39 months after an additional $500 President's Bonus Cash. This President's Celebration event ends February 28th, so visit your Chrysler dealer today.
Fans, go to www.io.tv/KnicksHD now. Sign up today for the best high-def programming. Also enter the IO Clear Winner Knicks Sweepstakes, your chance to win an HD Plasma TV and a dream suite for you and your friends at a Knicks home game. So get in on the action now and sign up for IO today. This past midway point of the second, Allen Iverson was complaining quite a bit early in the game. And he is now started to get to the free throw line. He got a technical early on as Crawford hits the technical on a defensive 3 seconds. Iverson has 20 points here in the first half. He had 29 in the first half the other night against Orlando when he had the 60. Crawford looking for Penny Hardaway. Aaron McKee does a good job fighting through. Stolen by Iverson. Poor pass from Tim Thomas.
Yeah, that's why Iverson averages 2 assists a game. That puts him among the leaders.
2 steals a game.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
And this is the largest lead here of the first half, an 11-point advantage. And another turnover. Back-to-back turnovers. Iverson hoists up a 3. And Josh Davis comes in. Josh Davis, he just clearly wanted the ball more than anyone else. Knicks was standing there looking, and Davis dove on the floor, blocked by Hardaway. Iverson puts it up. Shot won't go, and Sweetney with a tough rebound. Coming up on 5 minutes remaining. Ooh, almost another steal, and Thomas loses the ball.
Iguodala has 2 stuffs. Now give him three.
Herb Williams screaming. He felt that Iverson should have been called for a foul on Tim Thomas. Herb Williams now feeling that the Knicks being taken advantage of. But right now, the Sixers just playing a lot more aggressively. Thomas holding on to that left hand that's bothering him and is bandaged.
And they want to talk. The Knicks need a 20-second here to try to regroup.
An 18-5 run. Herb Williams starting with Bob Delaney right now. Felt there was a foul call. Meanwhile, the Sixers coming out strong here in the second.
And this is what happened. Contact by Iverson, no foul call. Iguodala right there to capitalize.
And a full timeout now. Just over 4.5 remaining in the second. Knicks now on a 13-point hole.
Six-speed, 270-horsepower Acura TL adjusts to the way each individual accelerates, brakes, and takes on the curves. Because no two drivers are alike. The Acura TL, a higher form of performance.
Someone has a love letter.
It's true. With NBA League Pass, you get up to 40 games a week. Yes, you can be a Kings fan in Philly and still watch them play. You think this year's rookies will be as good as last year? Do you want to follow your favorite fantasy players? Then NBA League Pass will make you a happier man.
Get NBA League Pass now for just $109. To order, call DirecTV, Dish Network, or your local cable provider.
Nobody delivers more New York sports news than MSG Sports Desk. 30 minutes of highlights, analysis, and interviews. MSG Sports Desk presented by Toyota, only on MSG.
A new computer virus? That sounds terrifically exciting.
New computer viruses? They could be nice.
I like virus protection that never updates, like my wardrobe.
Millions of Americans are just asking for a computer virus because they're not nearly as protected as they think they are.
Nostradamus made no mention of new viruses. So I'm cool.
That's why America Online now gives our members virus protection that updates automatically, absolutely free.
Awesome.
Want a better internet? You belong at America Online.
Stephon Marbury back in the game. And Knicks started to start their slide when Marbury went out. Right now, down by 13. Marbury drives, gets right past Iverson inside, draws some contact. And a foul call on Josh Davis.
That's what the Sixers have been trying to take away from the Knicks, dribble penetration, especially when Stephon is in the game. This is our Panasonic digital replay. The quickness of Stephon just checking into the game, eluding Iverson. There's the help. The contact is sending Steph to the line.
Marbury with his second free throw. He's got 13 points, 4 assists. Here Williams looking at Jason Phillips, who obviously doesn't agree with whatever Herb is saying right now. Point game, just under 4.5 to play in the second with Clyde Frazier, Mike Green on hand. He's trying to make it 3 straight over Philly, but Iverson is on a roll and fouled right away.
You see the coach not taking Iverson out. He's played most of the first half other than the 4:17 remaining and has been feasting from the free throw line.
You know what, Clyde? That one on Marbury's third. Right now, the way the game has been officiated here in the first half has been very inconsistent. In the first several minutes, they were letting players bang and go at it at both ends of the floor. And now all of a sudden, a little foul like that. Now it's being called. That's what drives a player crazy. And, you know, we're always applauding the officials, and rightfully so. But this is a very inconsistent first half, the way the game's been called, as Iverson will now shoot two.
And that's why this man is looking at his hand. In a call not made, Iverson going for the steal, ran into him, no foul called.
See him taking off a lot of the bandage there as Iverson comes up short that time. Mucci Norris is going to come in. Marbury will have to sit with 3 fouls. That's that left index finger, the one he's touching there, is the one that he sprained. And the one that's obviously causing him some discomfort. So Marbury's done for the half. Kurt Thomas with his 3 fouls done for the half for the Knicks. Down by 12.
Crawford has to try to provide the leadership now.
More importantly, Knicks need again to play better defense. Sweetney spinning inside, trying to draw a foul, and does so. Sweetney so tough inside, and he'll get two more free throws as D'Alembert called for his second.
Yeah, good perseverance by Sweetney, surrounded by Sixers, but able to go baseline. Watch the manipulation. A little shake and bake, getting D'Alembert in the air.
Sweetney, 3 points, three rebounds in the early going.
Obviously, the Knicks defense, the Sixers shooting 54%. Knicks have to tighten up that D, especially shut down the paint to Iverson. So he's been the culprit breaking down their defense.
Knicks have fallen to number 30, last in the NBA in opponents' field goal percentage. Opponents are shooting just under 47% against them. That is not a good number. Something first Lenny Wilkins preached, now Herb Williams. Knicks against, just not committed full time defensively. Nice time that time, Mucci Norris with the deflection. Crawford, an open look, knocks down the three.
That's who they should look for. That shot is there. Crawford can capitalize on the Sixers just packing it into the paint.
A little full court pressure against Iverson, who gets in the paint down the other end, trying to draw a foul, and he does. And now the Knicks very frustrated. Tony Brothers just said, enough, stop. I don't want to hear anymore. Every call has been argued here in the first half by both teams.
Take a look at Iverson, maintaining his dribble right inside of Norris. Right there, they call him, I guess, when his hand went up. See, this shot is there. Look at the Sixers all falling back. Crawford uncontested.
Yeah, that's a good three-pointer. He squared up his time.
Was in rhythm.
Yep.
In the floor of the game.
Iverson's been to the line 10 times already. Knicks as a team only 8.
So Hardaway and Crawford should be the guys look for here on the perimeter.
Iverson now, he's got 25 points, and we still have 3.5 to play. First half of Philadelphia, Knicks started strongly, went up by as many as 8, but now trailing by 9. That shot, a bad shot. D'Alembert the rebound.
Patience. The Knicks need patience now in the offense.
Iverson gets past Mucci Norris and draws another foul. And Norris called. Mucci Norris simply cannot guard Stephon Marbury.
Knicks need a zone now, man. They need to go into a collapsed zone like the Sixers so they can keep Iverson out of the paint. That's why they designed that defense to keep Stephon out of the paint. So the Knicks need to do a similar thing here.
Marbury with the 3 fouls, again having to sit. Iverson had 60 last game. He might be on his way to another one of those. And that's part of our trivia question. Let's get the answer now, our Nissan trivia.
I don't know the guy, but I cheated.
Maravich, Jordan, Jerry West.
Not West. West didn't do it. Iverson.
Tracy McGrady played a guard when he scored it, so I'm going to put McGrady in there. So it is Jerry West.
West. Yeah. They left him off the sheet.
Well, he scored it before in the last. That was in the what Clyde is referring to in the Sixers game notes. They had who scored 60 from 1979 on.
Why did they forget about us? The former greats of the game. Now the Sixers are regular man to man, not dropping back in the paint, just stand up on their man.
Crawford, tough shot.
Oh, yeah, Baker. Nice tip in.
Well, Ben Baker with a little tip.
That might give Baker some confidence.
Norris trying to stay with Iverson. Nice feet inside.
Jackson has been prospering. This is the easy shot.
Jackson, a primal scream in there, and a foul.
Jackson has been very efficient with the jumper on the perimeter. This time asserting himself in the paint with the second opportunity. Jackson 6'10", 255. Missed an easy opportunity, undaunted. There's the foul, and he's going to the line.
The Sixers out rebounding the Knicks by 11 here in the first half. And Jackson has been superb. 16 points, 7 of 9 from the field.
Iverson has had his way, and the Knicks is still only a run away from getting back into the game.
Free throw off the mark. Foul trouble has hurt the Knicks with Kurt Thomas and Stephon Marbury on the floor. Sixers are taking advantage. Knicks bench has not played well tonight. Crawford looks up, 7 on the shot clock. Norris tries some penetration. Crawford has to put it up. And Corver the rebound. Shot clock was winding down.
Here's Corver downtown.
Corver wide open. And that Tim Thomas shot, but does it go down? Stripped down low by Uchi Norris. Ball kicked out of bounds. It should be Nick Ball. It looked like Jackson hit it last, and it's going to be Nick Ball.
Good denial by Mucci. Norris was in there again. Jackson was in there. Watch Jackson. And the quick hands by Mucci and the kick by Jackson, so the Knicks have it.
11-point lead for Philly with a minute and a half to play. Shot clock at 3. And an offensive foul on Jerome Williams. And without Marbury and Kurt Thomas, the Knicks offense really, really struggling.
Well, give the Sixers some credit, man. They're playing a very vexing defense, helping out, dropping back, kind of confusing the Knicks right now.
Nazi Muhammad will come back in. Kurt Thomas has hardly played. Thomas with 6 minutes and 3 fouls. Jerome Williams will sit down. Williams picking up his 3rd foul.
Yep, they've taken Jerome out of the game because of the quick whistles.
Iverson on the pull-up. Iverson now with 29 points in the first half, same as he did in the last game against Orlando.
It looked like he might play 48 minutes tonight. He has not been taken out during the first half.
Most points by a Knick opponent in a half since Richard Hamilton in 2001 when he had 27. Hardaway under pressure, air ball. Mucci Norris trying to draw a foul and somehow slips it in.
Good aggression by the 5'11 Norris.
Norris takes it away. Nice defensive play from Mucci Norris.
Sixers do a good job in getting back.
Then Baker. And they call a foul on Corver. Corver was set, but he did not give Baker room to stop and change direction. Therefore, the call. Baker will shoot 2. They call it on Skinner. Excuse me.
Well, we've seen many dubious calls tonight. That was another one, but most of them have gone against the Knicks.
So Skinner with his 1st.
And Mike mentioned when you're the aggressor, you normally get the calls more than a team that's not being as aggressive. That's what's happening right now to the Knicks.
Well, Williams talked about that. He wanted his team to be more attacking, to stay aggressive. Coming up, the Tri-State Jeep Halftime Report. Jeep trail-rated capability only in the Jeep 4x4. Bill Daughtry at the sports desk. And John Andres will join me for first half highlights. A lot of them will be Allen Iverson highlights. 29 points for Iverson.
And he looked rested. He's not breathing hard at all yet.
He hasn't rested yet. He's been in the game the whole time. And Baker with just a silly foul from 25 feet from the basket. And Iverson's going to go to the line.
Yeah, he just Iverson feels invincible now. You know, if he gets inside, he's been getting the calls. And right there, hounding Baker into the foul.
So Iverson been to the line. This will be his 14th and 15th free throw attempt. Remember, he had 27 attempts the other night against Orlando.
You know, the knock against Iverson is that he doesn't like to practice. How good would he be if he practiced?
Well, according to Jim O'Brien and his staff, this year he has been practicing.
And maybe that's why he's better.
He's having a terrific year. All of his free throws, by the way, have come in the 2nd quarter. He's got 31. He's played the whole way here in the first half. 31 points. And we're just approaching halftime. We're going to have to start looking to see who's had back-to-back 60-point games if that's happened. Only one guy I can think of has a possibility.
Chamberlain, I'm sure, is surpassed that.
Knicks going backwards on offense here. Crawford. And a foul on Skinner.
And now the touch fouls, the quick whistles. And the players, as Mike mentioned, are baffled and befuddled now on what to do. Can't put your hands on them. You don't know when they're going to make a call.
Now, what happens sometimes is if officials start a game and let the players play and it starts to get out of hand where there's some extra pushing and shoving and it's far too physical, then they'll tighten it up. but it didn't seem like it was getting out of hand. It just all of a sudden the whistle started being a little different.
Only thing out of hand was Iverson. He got a technical because he was very vociferous in his complaint. Since then, he's gotten all the calls.
Skinner sits down with his second foul. Josh Davis back in. Crawford hits a pair.
And you can't believe the Knicks only down 10.
Despite Iverson's unbelievable first half.
Right, so they're right there. They just have to regroup at the half.
Iverson drives, kicks it. Jackson with the jumper. Iverson not only with the 31 points, but just dished off for his sixth assist. And the Knicks defense struggling against one of the most explosive scores in the history of the game. Allen Iverson, 31 points at halftime as the Sixers shoot 55% from the field and score 60 points in the opening two quarters. So halftime here at the Wachovia Center. If the Knicks are going to beat the Sixers for the third time this season, they'll need to come from behind like they did back in December and figure out some way to slow down Allen Iverson. A 12-point Knick deficit, 60-48 after two quarters here in Philadelphia.
Watch MSG Network and you could win a trip for two to see the Knicks battle the Magic live in Orlando. To enter, send a postcard to the address on your screen. The Knicks Magic Sweepstakes. Enter today.
Get the big picture when you add HBO and Cinemax. Enjoy all the biggest Hollywood hits, the biggest selection of acclaimed originals, and the biggest array of choices. All day, every day, on 10 great channels. Bring the big picture home. Order HBO and Cinemax online now at DirectTV.com or call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Get ready for something special from Starz and DirectTV. The Starz Free Preview Weekend, February 18th, 19th, and 20th. 12 movie channels all weekend long. On channels 520 through 533, sample Starz. The Starz Free Preview Weekend, only from DirecTV. Don't wait for the preview. Get Starz today and receive a free $20 Best Buy gift card. Visit DirectTV.com or call 1-800-DIRECTV and ask for Starz.
There's a whole new world of high-definition television to experience. And nobody takes you there like DirecTV HD. With more HD sports, more HD movies, more HD channels. With the widest variety of HD programming available, isn't it time to rethink the way you look at television? DirecTV HD.
I feel I'm entitled to inadequate computer virus protection.
I'd like a virus that makes my computer freeze up like a banana daiquiri.
Incomplete virus protection totally rocks.
Millions of Americans are just asking for a computer virus because they're not nearly as protected as they think they are.
My computer's only half protected. But then I live for danger.
That's why America Online now gives our members virus protection that works for your whole computer, not just email. Absolutely free.
That's nice.
Want a better internet? You belong at America Online.
I'm Ron Burgundy.
Anchorman's got the story, and he's unrated.
You have an absolutely breathtaking.
That's right, unrated.
Mr. Burgundy, you have a massive...
Really? Yes, I do.
Well, that's just great.
Their periods attract bears.
That doesn't make sense.
Too risque for theaters, just right for pay-per-view. Anchorman, the legend of Ron Burgundy, the unrated version, now on DirecTV pay-per-view.
Game's on.
Just listen to your Dell, man.
The battery's in the remote. That's not.
Get the silver key. Ah, the silver key!
Wow, that was the shot of the game.
Oh, that's just great.
Now is the perfect time to get great Dell gear, like this Dell HD Plasma TV for just $31.99 after $300 mail-in rebate. Plus, get a free Samsung DVD player. Dell Pocket DJs are just $199. Plus, get free shipping and lots of other great Dell deals. Just call or go online now. Get more out of now.
This copyrighted telecast of the National Basketball Association may not be retransmitted, reproduced, rebroadcast, or otherwise distributed or used in any form without the express written consent of the NBA.
You're watching the Tri-State Jeep Halftime Report. Jeep, trail-rated capability only in a Jeep 4x4.
Phil Daughtry at the MSG Sports Desk with a halftime update. Make sure you're watching Sports Desk after the game. The Yankees are already in Tampa, Florida, some of them working out. Derek Jeter in that mix. The Yankee captain and his teammate also fielding questions about steroids and teammate Jason Giambi.
I think just being here, obviously, you know, people are going to say things about you. You're going to have to try to put it out of your mind. So I'm sure it's going to be a challenge for Jason. But I can't comment on it because I don't know what it's going to be like. Yeah, I think no one knows what it's going to be like, but I'm sure it's going to be tough for him.
NBA basketball tonight in Detroit. Pistons, Bucks, Joe Smith, left-hand jam. Bucks with the early lead. Then Chauncey Billups later in the first. Provides a softer touch from downtown. It's money. Pistons and Detroit playing in Detroit. Pistons with the second quarter lead. New Jersey Nets are set to acquire Clifford Robinson from Golden State, the former UConn star, coming back east in exchange for two future second round draft picks and a Nets trade exception worth roughly $5 million. Arizona businessman Reggie Fowler has agreed to buy the Minnesota Vikings from Red McComb. He put the team on the market in 2002. Now, if the league approves the deal, Fowler would become the NFL's first black owner, something he says is both, quote, a great thing and not that big a deal. We'll tell you what's coming up on the late edition of Sports Desk after the game, after these messages.
Question over and over.
Can you hear me now?
So that you don't have to.
Good.
Verizon Wireless has fewer dropped calls than any other wireless network.
Good. Can you hear me now?
It's what makes us the most reliable wireless network in the nation.
Now. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? Good.
Verizon Wireless.
Can you hear me now?
We never stop working for you.
Good.
Later tonight on Sports Desk, the story of Hofstra wrestling coach Tom Ryan, who has built his team into a marvelous force. Well, he did it while enduring a personal situation that would be almost impossible for anyone to bear. More reasons to watch Sports Desk after Knicks basketball tonight on MSG.
It's the President's Celebration event at your Jeep dealer, where for a limited time, get a great deal on the all-new Jeep Grand Cherokee, including 0+, 0% financing, plus $1,000 in bonus cash. Or qualified buyers can get a 2005 Grand Cherokee Laredo for $299 a month for 39 months. And Grand Cherokee is completely redesigned, both inside and out. But this President's Celebration event ends February 28th, so visit your Jeep dealer today.
Afternoon, one of our advisors showed this dad how to protect his family and still retire at 55. Yeah.
All shave gels are full of soap, and soap can leave your skin dry and irritated. Introducing Gillette Complete Multi-Gel, the only shave gel without soap, so you get healthy-looking skin. This is more than shave gel. This is skincare for a man. Gillette Complete Multi-Gel.
In tennis, love means nothing. Yes. In life, it means everything.
I know that Lizzie likes to have her fun. This time it's different. She's falling for you.
Paul Bettany and Kirsten Dunst.
I need you to go.
No, you need me to stay.
Wimbledon, then.
Let's do this.
Get a double dose of Kirsten Dunst in Bring It On. Now, order these two great movies for one low price.
We might have to have a rumble.
Wimbledon, Bring It On. Now playing on pay-per-view.
A new computer virus? That sounds terrifically exciting.
New computer viruses? They could be nice.
I like virus protection that never updates, like my wardrobe.
Millions of Americans are just asking for a computer virus because they're not nearly as protected as they think they are.
Nostradamus made no mention of new viruses. So I'm cool.
That's why America Online now gives our members virus protection that updates automatically, absolutely free.
Awesome.
Want a better internet? You belong at America Online.
Get the big picture when you add HBO and Cinemax. Enjoy all the biggest Hollywood hits, the biggest selection of acclaimed originals, and the biggest array of choices. All day, every day, on 10 great channels. Bring the big picture home. Order HBO and Cinemax online now at DirectTV.com or call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Time in Philadelphia, and the Knicks trailing the 76ers 60-48 here on Valentine's Day. They have Chuck Woolery. There he is, the actual man at the Wachovia Center, and they're playing a Valentine's Day with Matt Cord, the PA announcer of the 76ers, in a rendition of the dating game, and it has been a nightmare, as every answer pretty much has been booed by this brutal Philly crowd. It just has not worked out with the kind of love they expected here. Meanwhile, our halftime score summary brought to you by Jeep, trail-rated capability, only in a Jeep 4x4. That's right, Iverson at halftime, 31 points. He went to the free throw line 15 times. He also had 6 assists, and Mark Jackson off the bench, superb for Philadelphia. Meanwhile, for the Knicks, Stephon Marbury had 14, but he was in foul trouble, as was Kurt Thomas, and the Knicks, in some ways, fortunate to be only down by 12. Hello, everyone. Now joined by John Andres, Mike Breen on hand. It's been a disaster. They booed Santa Claus here in Philly. Now they're booing the people who are trying to win a date on the dating game. Meanwhile, the Knicks could care less, John. They have to figure out a way somehow to slow down Allen Iverson.
Ironically, he didn't score this much in any of the games against the Knicks this year. The two games the Knicks won, he didn't even have 30 points in the game. I think the guy that may even concern the Knicks more is Mark Jackson. He's 8 out of 10 from the field. He's a guy who averages 11 points a game. Mike, the effort isn't there. The awareness of staying in front, I mean, obviously you can't stay in front of Iverson all the time, certainly. There's got to be some kind of team help on this situation. And under the boards, the Knicks are doing a very poor job. They're being out-rebounded badly. The big men have to play physically, which they're not doing.
The problem is, though, the big men have to so worry about guarding those in the paint that sometimes they're out of position. Let's look at some of the highlights. Halftime highlights brought to you by Jeep, trail-rated capability, only in a Jeep 4x4.
Well, there's one man really turning it on for the Sixers, of course, in terms of penetration, and that's this man. Allen Iverson, he just seems so much faster than anybody on the court tonight. I mean, the Knicks can't even seem to draw a charge on him. He's just outrunning everybody. A spectacular performance for him following his 60-point effort the other night. He's just beating everybody. And even though he's been to the line so much, it looks like there are opportunities to foul him and stop him from making these field goals. Marbury also with a couple of sensational moves himself earlier in the half before the foul sent him to the bench. He would respond very well to some of Iverson's sensational movement himself. Nice handoff there from Jamal Crawford. One of the nice moments for the Knicks in the first half.
Meanwhile, as you said, John, Knicks out rebounded 25-14 in that first half. And yes, Stephon Marbury and Kurt Thomas, their foul trouble had a lot to do with it. They were out of the game for a good portion of the first half. But it's just a matter of taking pride and making a commitment to guard your own men and not always relying on help.
I get the feeling, too, that the Knicks big guys are being bullied, Mike. They're being pushed around, in a sense, for the position that the Sixers won on the court. And that's kind of infuriating. You know, I think it must be infuriating to a big man like Herb Williams, too, to see that. Knicks have to show some fury out here in the second half in one form or another, I think.
And put a body on men more often.
Actually, yeah, absolutely.
All right, so the Knicks down by 12. Again, in some ways it should have been more, by the way. Allen Iverson dominated. Thank you, John Andres. But they'll try and bounce back here in the third quarter. Down in Philadelphia on Valentine's Day. Knicks down by a dozen.
You've been watching the Tri-State Jeep Halftime Report. Jeep, trail-rated capability only in a Jeep 4x4.
Panasonic introduces high-definition plasma TV with the most beautiful picture in the world. Yours.
No, it's mine.
It's my vacation. It's gotta be my game.
Make it yours. Just snap it and share it instantly with built-in photo viewer.
The most beautiful picture in the world. I'm pretty sure it's mine.
High-definition plasma TV from Panasonic. Ideas.
Get the fastest home internet access and unlimited calling with the Optimum Double Play. A special offer for our cable TV customers. Optimum Online and Optimum Voice, each just $29.95 a month for a year when you buy both together. Want the fastest home internet access? $29.95 a month gets you a full year of Optimum Online. More than triple the speed of DSL, more than 150 times faster than dial-up, and rated number one by readers of PC Magazine. Want unlimited calling? $29.95 a month gets you a full year of Optimum Voice. Call anywhere in the U.S. and Canada as often as you like for one low monthly rate. You already have the best cable TV. Now add the fastest home internet access and unlimited local and long distance calling. Each just $29.95 a month for a year when you buy both together. Save over $250. The Optimum Double Play. Call 1-866-GET-BOTH. Don't miss this special offer, only from Cablevision.
Powerful line of the best-selling vehicles on the planet. Now starting at just $199 a month for a Ford Explorer Sport Track. A well-equipped 4x4 XLT edition for an incredibly low $199 for a limited time.
Cheerleaders witness a murder. You're the only team that can protect them.
You girls are cheerleaders, huh? Back in my day,
we brought it.
Man of the House, rated PG-13. It appears that worth within.
New York Knicks basketball brought to you part by Office Depot. What you need to know. By your local Tri-State quality Ford store with the best-selling vehicles on the planet. And by Panasonic, ideas for life. Third quarter is set to begin in Philadelphia. Knicks trailing the Sixers 60-48. Of course, the All-Star break coming up. Our North Fork Bank upcoming schedule. Knicks will finish before the break at home against Milwaukee. Then the All-Star weekend. And then a tough start in Detroit next Tuesday. Canada Business Solution Knicks game night preceding all games. Yeah, that's why this game, an important one for the Knicks, Clyde. If they could win and then win against Milwaukee Wednesday, at least have a little bit of a good feeling going into the All-Star break with possibly a three-game winning streak. But to do that, they've got to start playing some defense because it just is not there once again.
Right. And also, folks, it's not about injuries right now, poor execution, turnovers, missed free throws. It's all about pride and fortitude and not embarrassing yourself. So the Knicks have to come out here and play some basketball. No more excuses. They've got to stop Iverson. He's been the main culprit and breaking down their defense, so they have to come out with some tenacity and get some of these calls that the Sixers are getting.
Let's take a look at some of the numbers from the first half. And again, you look at the opponent's field goal percentage, and that's the one that jumps out at you, 55% from the field. And this is a Philly team that for the season, their team shoots 43%, yet they're at 55 here in the first half. And 20 free throw attempts in the first half. Herb Williams trying to do something.
Right, every man has to carry his own weight. Don't look for help. Just get up on your man, keep him in front of you, and see if the Knicks will try to put a zone up against Iverson to keep him out of the paint in the second half.
Iverson had 29 in the first half against Orlando, finished with a career high 60. He's got 31 here in the first half. It'll be interesting to see Clyde if he tries to again get to that point again in terms of looking to get the scoring record, or he just gets it into the flow, although he's pretty much the flow of their offense.
And also he's played 24 minutes. You can see he's rarely worked up a sweat. So I was surprised that the coach would keep him out there like that, but obviously they know something we do not, so I would not be surprised to see him play the entire game.
Well, he never wants to come out. Remember Larry Brown talking about how Iverson would play 46 minutes during the course of the game. But when he took him out for those 2 minutes, Iverson, the whole time he was on the bench, those 2 minutes was like begging to get back in. He never wants to come out of the game.
That's why Stephon has to challenge him. As you mentioned, make him play defense on the other end. So that way, when you have to think defense, that affects your offense.
Marbury did have a good offensive first half, 14 points, 6 of 8 from the field. He had 4 assists, and he only played 16 minutes because he picked up 3 fouls. But he has to make a more Carter on the other end of the floor.
See if Kirk Thomas can get back into it as well. Never got into flow because of early fouls.
Marbury, the penetration inside. Shot won't go. And D'Alembert the rebound. Iverson throws it behind Iguodala. Corliss Williamson back in. He was most likely not to return after hurting his back, but he's obviously okay. And lead up to 14. This is the largest of the game.
Muhammad has not been a factor. Obviously, that groin injury hindering his play.
Shot clock at 8. Crawford gets in the paint. Tough fall away shot from Crawford. Nice move from Jamal Crawford. He's got 11.
Coach yelling, get up into them. Herb wants them up. Be aggressive.
The Sixers with a much more physical team in the first half. Korver for 3. D'Alembert tips it right to Kirk Thomas.
Korver yet to score in the game. 0 for 4 now.
Muhammad
also.
And he carried it.
Muhammad also zeros in the game. No points in 9 minutes of action as he turns it over.
Again, it's clear Nazi Muhammad is far from 100% with that strained groin. Give him some credit for being out there. Talking to the Knicks staff, it's a type of injury that you need rest, but he wanted to play until the All-Star break and then would get his rest. Williamson kicks it out. And whistle, we were blocked out. Couldn't see what the call is, but it's going to go against Tim Thomas.
On Iverson. At the last minute, Iverson dished it off. Arch Iverson, the whistle was late. So if he had thrown this towards the basket, he'd be on the line now. But since he passed it, his non-shooting Sixers have it adjacent to the Knicks bench.
Knicks for the penalty very early in that second quarter. Korver, there's a 3 from Korver. His first 3-pointer of the game. Any second in the NBA in 3-pointers made and attempted. And a lead now 15. Good defense from Iguodala. Muhammad. And Nazi Muhammad with his first shot attempt in his 11 minutes of play. Again, the Knicks came down from 19 down in the fourth quarter to beat the Sixers. That was back in December. Jerome Williams was the key spark in that comeback. Williamson.
Good harassing Nick D there.
And Williamson still puts it in. That's a 2-pointer from Corliss Williamson.
Nothing frustrates the defense more than that. You expend a lot of energy and they come up with a shot to beat the shot clock.
15-point deficit for the Knicks. 2.5 gone by here in the third.
Sixers continue to play this vexing double teaming style of defense and frustrating the Knicks as they turn it over.
9th turnover. Marbury needs to continue to attack like he did in the first half. The offense was doing well because Iverson is not a good defender. Yes, he's amongst the leaders in steals, but it's more on his gambling.
Good double there, but Iguodala spinning and missing the jumper.
Marbury finding Tim Thomas. Crawford, quick shot, hits a 3. Jamal Crawford from downtown. Knicks now 4 of 10 from long range. And it's back to within 12. You can see that it's much more physical defensively as Iverson gets it out to Korver. Korver, another three.
After not scoring, missing his first four shots, two consecutive threes for Korver.
And it's back up to 15.
That's why you can ill afford to trade hoops. The Knicks need turnovers if they score.
And Kirk Thomas with a nice touch. Thomas again only played in that first half 5 minutes. Iverson for three.
Iverson only a 29% shooter from downtown. League average is around 35%.
That's his numbers this year. First career, only 31%. So he's never been a very good three-point shooter. Marbury shot hits the front of the rim. And because of the rotation goes through.
Soft baskets here. So he was able to get a break with the bounce.
16 points to Marbury. Marbury's shooting well. He's 7 of 10.
Now they're featuring Iverson behind the back. Pass to Williamson.
Williamson goes inside, can't hit, fight for the rebound. Crawford comes away. The Knicks guards need to help out on the boards as the Sixers dominating the rebounding edge in that first half. Marbury gets in, flips it up, shot won't go. Herb Williams yelling to get back.
And this is why Korver, nice interior pass.
And Tim Thomas, all he did was just lean in to smack. Corliss Williamson didn't try and make a play on the ball or the defender. And he picks up his second foul.
Very unselfish play by Korver. He's made his last through two threes. He was open there. But this man had a better opportunity, so nice dish inside.
So Corliss Williamson to shoot.
Williamson, former sixth man of the year recipient in 02 with the Pistons.
Well, a guy who's won an NCAA title and an NBA title. Did so with Arkansas back in 94 and the Pistons last year.
Out of Arkansas. The Big Nasty.
Played with Sacramento, Toronto, Philly, and Detroit. 72-59. Knicks trail. Coming up on 5 minutes gone by here in the third. Knicks came out early in this one, if you're just joining us, led by as many as eight, but now then Allen Iverson erupted. At 31 points in the first half, as you have to score here on the third. Thomas cuts to the basket. And nice feed for Muhammad.
And again, the Knicks only a run away.
But to get that run going, also need some stops, and they have not been able to do that. Iverson, not a good shot that time. Ball tipped by Crawford. Nice job from Crawford because D'Alembert had a beat on the ball. Crawford down the other end, flips it up, shot won't go. Kirk Thomas the rebound.
Yeah, Tim Thomas over again. Crawford a second opportunity, he scores.
So Crawford, good hustle at both ends of the floor, and all of a sudden it's an 8-point game.
Yep.
Knicks have come out differently defensively, much more physical. And Crawford helping out to start, and the Knicks on a 9-2 run. Yeah.
Good second opportunity for Crawford. Draining the three-pointer right in front of the Sixer bench.
Powerful line of the best-selling vehicles on the planet. Now starting at just $199 a month for a Ford Explorer Sport Track. A well-equipped 4x4 XLT edition for an incredibly low $199 for a limited time.
Hello, hi, how are you? Great opening, has some samples. Hey.
Hello.
Hey, grand opening.
Foxwoods Resort Casino, 80 poker tables, a charter member of the World Poker Tour. Come to Foxwoods and check out the latest, our new Hard Rock Cafe.
At Lexus, we understand it's hard to predict what you might encounter on the road. That's why the Lexus ES comes with front-wheel drive and available vehicle stability control. Because the elements aren't the only challenges in winter.
See your New York, New Jersey, Connecticut Lexus dealer.
Knicks down by 8, 6.5 to play here in the third. Knicks and the Bucks coming up Wednesday night. Last game before the All-Star break. Kind of business solution. Knicks game night at 7. Tip-off at 7:40. Well, Knicks turning around a little bit here in the third quarter, Clyde. Playing a little more physical on defense. And they're 7 of 10 from the field on the offensive end.
Crawford providing the impetus from downtown.
Wallace Williamson. Kurt Thomas defended him well. And the rebound. And a lot of what had to do in the first half was Marbury and Kurt Thomas being in foul trouble. The Knicks bench did not play well in the first half.
Good duping by Curtin, who is in and out.
And the ball taken by Williamson.
What has happened to McKee's game? Aaron McKee, an excellent defender, hometown guy as well.
He doesn't play a lot as much anymore. He's only averaging about 13 minutes a game. He's broken down, Clyde. He's had a lot of injuries over the last several years.
Yeah, he's a pure shooter.
Shot clock at 5. Korver, his third three-pointer, and Herb Williams very upset.
Yeah, Herb had a good look at it. It was right in front of the Knicks bench.
And just when the Knicks had gone on a bit of a roll, Korver puts it back up to double figures, an 11-point lead.
See, the Sixers sort of a zone collapsing defense now.
And Marbury with the offensive rebound. Crawford.
Oh, he wanted to pass and then shoot. A good improvisation by Crawford.
You know, Clyde, I was just going to say it's a bad shot, and it was a bad shot, but he's still able to put it in.
That's why you do not want to jump in the air looking to pass.
Iverson. And Muhammad knocks it out of the hands of D'Alembert. And D'Alembert will shoot some free throws as Muhammad picks up his second.
Basketball is a game of improvisation. Watch Crawford. See, he's looking to dish. The guy got in the passing lane, so he had to shoot. And he was able to get it down.
You see Mike Malone. Mike Malone has been very instrumental in trying to help Jamal Crawford turn around his game. Malone, of course, the son of Brendan Malone. He told Crawford before the year, he gave him statistics on how many three-pointers he's taken in his career and how many free throws. And he said, you're a terrific free throw shooter. You need to get to the line more. Stop settling for threes. Try and make it different. He says Crawford's been very coachable, trying to listen, but it's tough habits to break. But he's got a lot of confidence that Crawford's going to be able to turn it around and get to the line more often.
But in last night, we saw Crawford penetrating more. So when he has good games, he shows that versatility in his game, not just a perimeter shooter, but also good creativity off the dribble.
You see Kevin Ollie guarding Marbury. Iverson sits down for the first time tonight. Part of it, he's got to get stronger, Clyde. I mean, he's so quick, and he's got such a great crossover move. That time fires up a three.
Yeah, he can get a better shot than that.
Absolutely.
He can get any shot that he wants with his handle, but it's just settling for that shot. Not a good one.
See, obviously, he's not happy. Now he's not happy. He wants to come back in the game now. He had 31 in the first half, did not score yet here in the third quarter.
Iverson credited with the first guy to have the corn rolls in his head, set in that style in the NBA. Maybe the tattoo. No, that was Dennis. Dennis the Menace Rodman.
There's McKee. Kevin Ollie fires away, and Ollie drops it down.
Ollie with his 10th team, folks. He's been just reactivated. A good shot that time.
He's a terrific backup point guard. A lot of experience. He's fought through a lot of tough times, ups and downs in the NBA, but he's a real pro. 12-point game.
There's nothing on the interior for the Knicks. You see they're tripling that. So Stephon and Crawford and Tim must look for those perimeter shots. They're there.
Shot clock at 9.
But you got to pass the ball 3 or 4 times in order to get an uncontested shot.
Marbury pushed down by Ollie. And for the Sixers, that's just their first team foul. And Ollie picks up his first. Knicks will reset the shot clock to 14.
So the Knicks need patience and poise here to exploit this collapsing, doubling defense of the Sixers.
You see Herb Williams up near half court. He's right in front of us, Clyde. Would you ask him to get out of the way?
Yo, Herb.
Tim Thomas, rifle pass. Marbury spots up and hits the 2. And the Knicks back within 10. Marbury with 18. Crawford, meanwhile, with 19. Here's Ollie.
Knicks bench yelling, step up.
Jackson can't hit. And Kurt Thomas with another rebound.
Jackson outscored the entire Nick Bench in the first half, had 18 points. Nick Bench had 14.
Marbury hits a three. Stephon Marbury from downtown, and just like that, it's a 7-point game.
And again, the perimeter shots. Stephon, the last two uncontested.
And also, Clyde, Knicks have out-rebounded the Sixers 10-3 here in the third quarter. That's the effort stat. Crawford comes right back. Jamal Crawford looking down at Korver as if to say, oh, I don't believe this guy.
He's made four consecutive threes after missing his four first shots.
All four of his threes in this third quarter. Marbury. Marbury shot short. McKee gets a running start on the rebound and barrels into Kurt Thomas.
But Kurt was standing there.
And an offensive foul call on McKee.
Yeah, McKee lost the handle. Very intrepid play by Kurt, sacrificing his body as we've seen throughout his career as a Knick. This is our Panasonic digital replay. McKee, 6'5", hell bent. Thomas willing to sacrifice his body, taking the blow right there. So we return, the Knicks will have it in the front court.
Wednesday on MSG, Stephon Marbury and the Knicks are back at the Garden to take on Michael Redd and the Bucks. The Knicks and the Bucks, Wednesday night, only on MSG Network.
I love the way you've decorated in here.
Want to get away? Now you can. Fly on Southwest Airlines with our $39 to $149 internet specials to 59 destinations nationwide.
You are now free to move about the country.
Get ready for something special from Starz and DirecTV. The Starz Free Preview Weekend, February 18th, 19th, and 20th. 12 movie channels all weekend long. On channels 520 through 533. Sample Starz. The Starz Free Preview Weekend, only from DirecTV. Don't wait for the preview. Get Starz today and receive a free $20 Best Buy gift card. Visit DirecTV.com or call 1-800-DIRECTV and ask for Starz.
I feel I'm entitled to inadequate computer virus protection.
I'd like a virus that makes my computer freeze up like a banana daiquiri.
Incomplete virus protection totally rocks.
Millions of Americans are just asking for a computer virus because they're not nearly as protected as they think they are.
My computer's only half protected. But then I live for danger.
That's why America Online now gives our members virus protection that works for your whole computer, not just email. Absolutely free.
That's nice.
Want a better internet? You belong at America Online.
MSG Network brings you the latest viewing innovations such as Game Director, Virtual Sports Desk, and HDTV Game Telecast. Improve your home viewing experience with these great options available on IO Digital Cable Service from Cablevision. Call your local cable operator today and ask for these enhanced channels. Knicks down 10, 2:45 left in the third. You know, Cry, people always ask, is Iverson ready to come back in? What's the toughest arenas to play in for visitors? And, you know, Detroit is one of them, but Philly is right up there. And the fans here behind the Knicks bench, as always, as Crawford puts up a three, short, no good. McKee the rebound. They have been brutal tonight. I got heckled at halftime. They booed the poor contestants on the dating game they did at halftime. It's a rough crowd, and they've been getting on Kurt Thomas. Thomas has something going with one of the fans trying to stare him down, which is not going to work. Kevin Ollie off the dribble. And foul. Again. The Knick guards have to do a better job defensively.
Yeah, Ollie going baseline. Able to find that big nasty, so he's at the line. Watch Kevin Ollie. Good job keeping his head up. Right there. No one in the passing lane to deny that pass.
Iverson returns. Didn't look to shoot much in the third quarter. 0 for 3. And Williamson. Again, he started, hurt his back initially, went out of the game. Now has 9 points. Biggest lead has been 15. That was here on the third. Knicks then cut that to 7. Now it's back up to 12.
And now the Knicks are shooting further and further from the basket. Both Crawford and Stephon now have lost their patience.
Marbury against Ollie.
And when the Knicks made their run, they were getting better percentage shots.
What happens, Clyde, lots of time when they throw it into the paint, you have four guys on the perimeter. They need guys to cut the lanes when they throw it down low.
Right, because once you start making shots, they have to respect that. So that should open up the interior. But again, the patience, you got to take your time and move the ball and make the defense move.
Thomas missed the first man coming out and has to call a timeout. So Herb Williams will use his 22nd timeout. You know, Herb Williams has had some impassioned speeches to the team in the locker room after some games. He's gone on the team about their efforts sometimes, especially their defense commitment. Not an easy situation to take over midway through a season, especially as a rookie coach. He has the respect of the players, but the way the players can respect him back is by playing with spirit, playing with intensity and energy and effort every night.
Well, he's gained my respect. He looks the part. He doesn't look rattled when things go awry. He speaks confidently, so I'm impressed with her.
Absolutely, Clyde. He's shown a lot of poise in a difficult situation.
And the main thing we mentioned, he doesn't have the ego problem. Nothing has changed. He still talks to us like he's the assistant coach. Comes to the back of the plane. I call him the cookie monster. I mean, you used to get those bags of cookies to take off the plate.
He was asked the other day about the stress of the job. Nice move from Muhammad. And he said, I love this job. And I'm going to do the best with what I can and work as hard as I can, just like he was as a player. He's always been a class act and continuing working as hard as he can.
So we like to see the team. They like him to respond by showing aggressive play out there.
Blocked by Tim Thomas. Crawford fouled by Williamson and then fouled by Kevin Ollie. And Sixers not the penalty. First foul in the last 2 minutes. So the Knicks will inbound down 10.
Better interior defense now by the Knicks. So forcing that turnover, the Knicks have it along the side. And we've seen some dismal third quarters by the Knicks, but this is a good one. I know a lot of duress, and they were able to respond. There's Nazi.
Ball knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Knicks. One other thing on Herb Williams, in talking to a number of players who played, we saw Doc Rivers and a lot of his former teammates, and when they played with Herb Williams, they knew he was going to be a coach. He's one of those players, when he was on the bench, was always talking strategy. And you knew that's where he wanted to be. He had a terrific mind for the game. As Nazi Muhammad fouls Iverson, who gets into the paint once again.
And the Knicks in the penalty, so more free throws coming for AI, as he's affectionately called around the league.
Has a chance for his first points of the third quarter. Now that explosive first half.
You mentioned Iverson has been the MVP. That was in 01. Three-time scoring champion. Holds the franchise records for threes made and attempted, but that man might break it one day. So the scoring rampage that Iverson has been on continues unabated.
12-point game as we approach a minute remaining here in the third. Crawford comes up. Iverson's on him now. Kevin Ollie's on Marvin.
Look how high the Knicks are. Look where they are. 30 feet away. That's where you need to be, right in there, where you can attack the basket.
Crawford falls down. Terrific move, but that was defended well. As Corliss Williamson, I think, got a piece of it.
The Knicks must know wherever you go, you're going to be double. So keep your head up and try to look for the open man.
It was Mark Jackson. Excellent defensive play from Mark Jackson.
Nice screen right there to free up Iverson.
And offensive foul on Allen Iverson.
Thomas doing a good job of using the baseline as an extra man. So Iverson had two choices. He could have stepped out of bounds or charged over Kurt, so he took the charging violation.
So Iverson picks up the personal second charge. Thomas is drawn, and Kevin Ollie called for a reach-in. And now Philly and the penalty, so Marbury will shoot two.
Watch Kurt, how he plays the D. Using the baseline as an extra man, cutting off Iverson. So he had the two charges, could have stepped out of bounds on a charging violation. So excellent D by Kurt.
Sixers have taken twice as many free throws so far than the Knicks is Marbury.
Steph has had his woes from the line recently. Very erratic shooting, especially down the stretch.
Marbury from the line, 2 for 4 in this game.
Weird game. Looked like the Knicks would be blown out. Fell behind by 15. But they played a nice third quarter, but you see they continue to trail.
Williamson spinning. Tim Thomas knocks it away. So does Muhammad. Williamson gets it back, and they're going to jump ball. Basketball count, jump ball.
Again, good vexing interior D by the Knicks. Good sleight of hand. Frustrating Williamson. See, there's a double by Tim Thomas. The Thomas is doing a good job, and there they call the jump ball scenario.
I don't know if it looked like it left Williamson's hand. But they're going to reset the shot clock. 18.2 left on the game clock, and the shot clock holding at 11.
Williamson obviously lacking agility and mobility because of his back woes, so Knicks have been able to frustrate him in the paint.
Bob Delaney getting in between Williamson and Thomas. And Thomas does a good job to win the tip. Shot clock turned off. Final shot of the third quarter. Knicks trying to cut the deficit to single digits here.
Both teams in the penalty. No fouls to give.
Crawford. Shot won't go. Iguodala the rebound. Would not have counted anyway. And that will end the third quarter. Knicks were down by 12 at half, went up to 15. They cut it to 7 at one point. And as we head to the fourth, they're down 11.
Introducing the all-new compact Mercury Mariner with intelligent four-wheel drive and V6 power. Mariner is everything you want in an SUV, only condensed. The smartly equipped Mercury Mariner starts at an introductory price under $22,000.
The AIG companies have the financial strength to cover just about anyone's insurance needs. From the chairman of the board to the baby on board. No matter what size your business or family, $700 billion in assets means the AIG companies will be there. Insurance, loans, retirement. AIG. We know money.
Fans, visit your local Verizon Wireless retail store to buy the new AudioVox CDM8910 camera phone. AudioVox is proud to be a presenting sponsor of Knicks basketball.
Lead in three different bands. I've been on stage at CBGB's and other clubs downtown. I've also got a van which can pretty much haul all this stuff around, so.
Cool, you're in.
That's all right, I don't really like Heineken.
What did it mean, create these differences?
New York Knicks basketball brought to you in part by Tri-State Lincoln Mercury Dealer and by Cannon Business Solutions, your source for document management. Fourth quarter set to begin in Philadelphia, and the Knicks trailing the 76ers 85-74. Clyde, what do they need to do here in the first couple of minutes of the period?
Well, continue to do what they did in the third quarter. Very cohesive offense, a vexing defense. The guard-oriented team responded with Stephon and Crawford providing the offense.
Trevor Ariza checks in. Michael Sweetney's in, along with Hardaway, Kurt Thomas, and Marbury.
We'll look for Iverson to be more offensive-minded this quarter. It was on cruise control the third quarter.
Iverson fires away with a hand in his face. Knicks defended him well, and Trevor Ariza with the rebound. It was a game back in December 17th, last time the Knicks played here. They trailed by 19 with 10:51 remaining. Came back, forced overtime, and won it in OT. Hardaway won't go, and Sweetney with a little putback.
Knicks need to up the tempo. The Sixers want to slow down the rhythm of the game now.
And Iverson foul on his way to the basket. Hardaway in frustration picks up the foul.
See, Hardaway, rather than reaching, should move his feet to impede Iverson's way with his body. See, watch Penny. Should move his body there. Watch his hand, you see. Should get his body in front of Iverson, make him dish the ball off.
Iverson, if you're just tuning in, had 31 points at halftime, but sat out a bit in the third and did not score until late in the period in the third quarter. And has 33 as D'Alembert short. For all the dominance of Iverson early, the Knicks slowly got back into this in the third quarter, at least in terms of physical play. Penny Hardaway gets a three. Penny Hardaway from downtown, and this is the closest the Knicks have been in the second half. All of a sudden, what was a 15-point game has been cut to six.
And the Knicks' body language very good now. Very active out there. Good communication on the defense.
Williamson tied up. Aaron McKee on the drive. And a foul call on Trevor Ariza on the pass.
Fouls on Trevor Ariza is next.
Take a look at Aaron McKee. Pure shooter. Creating off the dribble that time. And this is Hardaway. Previously missed the 18-footer. But able to drain this three-pointer to get the Knicks a little closer.
Iguodala was not off the court when it was inbounded yet. They had six players.
Should be a violation.
Well, it's more the officials. The officials should not have let him inbound the ball until the other player was off. Bob Delaney, the crew chief's gathering, and they're going to decide what to do.
Yep.
Jason Phillips to the left, Delaney in the middle, and Tony Brothers, number 25, with our is back to us.
Who said three heads are better than two?
There's Jim O'Brien. This is a smart thing to do, talk it out and see exactly what happened.
Well, this is what I like about the officials. They are not too proud to say we made a mistake and change it. And that's why we respect what they do.
Everybody says something. Aaron McKee. McKee coming over to talk with Williams.
And here comes the gracious Philly crowd. Starting to boo. It should be a technical. Too many guys on the court. It has to be.
And that's what they call.
Yep.
Jim O'Brien says that's a bad call. I think what he's saying is that why should we be penalized when the official should not have put the ball in play until the other player got off? That's my interpretation of what I think he's thinking. I don't know for sure. Hardaway hits it, and it's a 5-point game.
But the confusion was caused by O'Brien because he didn't put his guys in time, and that's why it occurred. So he had to pay.
The fans right behind us and behind the Knicks bench, just brutal on the officials. And I think the fans are so close to the court here, it's hard not to hear it.
Knicks sort of a zone now. We wonder when they might show this.
Aaron McKee on the pull up. And a tough shot from McKee. The old pro from Philadelphia. And it's back to a 7-point game.
Yeah, John Chaney product out of Temple.
And a foul on Iverson. Inadvertent trip on Stephon Marbury. He disagrees with the call.
Aaron McKee and Eddie Jones played at Temple as well. They did a book on their coach.
Mark Jackson played there as well.
Extolling the virtues. I would have never played for him, Mike, with those 6 o'clock practices. 6 a.m., folks.
Ariza, a lot of contact. Herb Williams upset. He has a right to be. Ariza got whacked.
Yeah, well, make it 5 a.m.
5 or 6 didn't really matter to you. Iverson, tough shot from Allen Iverson.
But I was talking with Earl Monroe. He said John was never there. So his coaches were doing the coaching.
Lead back up to 9. Feet inside to Sweetney. Knocked away by Korver. And here comes Iverson the other way.
Turnovers have not been a problem for the Knicks tonight. Now they're starting.
Ariza just grabbed Korver. McKee spots up for 3. And Kurt Thomas the rebound.
The game is starting to get a tempo now. The Knicks can capitalize on the up tempo. Sixers want to slow it down since they have the lead.
Hardaway off the dribble. And Hardaway puts it in. Nice adjustment. Almost the same move as Crawford. Looked like he wanted to kick it out right, but then put the little floater in.
And that's the value of maintaining your dribble. See, Hardaway never gave up his dribble, and you can create something as he did that time.
Herb Williams really shouting out a lot of instructions. Williamson gets inside. Blocked with a foul. Michael Sweetney called for the foul. And we'll have a timeout.
Let's take a look at Hardaway now. Previously, we told his virtues from downtown. Watch the good creativity here. Maintaining that dribble and able to can the 10-foot jumper.
Wow. Here's your Bud Light.
Thank you.
You know, I think I'm just going to go freshen up a bit, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Look at that.
It's so funny that you like to dance as much as I like to dance.
Hey, yeah. Really well, she's a little annoying, but I'm desperate. Oh, gotta go.
Oh, did you meet Coop?
Coop?
She's annoying, but I'm desperate. She's annoying, but I'm desperate.
What's that all about?
Fresh, smooth, real Bud Light.
Nice try, pretty boy.
It's all here.
The New York Knicks look better than ever in high definition on MSG Network, powered by Panasonic. See the crystal clear difference of Knicks basketball and HDTV. The difference is widescreen coverage of all the dazzling game action. The sharpest images, along with Dolby Digital Sound. See more of the game like you've never seen it before. Join the high-def revolution for a breathtaking home viewing experience. The Knicks on MSG Network in stunning high definition. Available on IO Digital Cable Service from Cablevision.
This is Principal Turner. Due to the inclement weather, we are closing school.
The all-wheel drive RX-330 at your New York, New Jersey, Connecticut Lexus dealer.
Enter the Champion Mortgage Knicks Magic Sweepstakes for your chance to win a trip to Orlando. Just send a postcard to the address on the screen. You might get a chance to win a trip to Orlando and go to the Knicks Magic game. Champion Mortgage, call 1-800-CHAMPION today. 8:41 remaining, fourth quarter here in Philadelphia. Knicks hanging around. They've been as close as 5 here in the fourth period. They've trailed by as many as 15 in the second half, and right now down 7 as Williamson to the line.
The exploits of Hardaway getting the Knicks a little closer, but previously Williams in the paint able to draw a foul, so he's shooting 2.
There's Mike Saunders, longtime athletic trainer for the Knicks. This was moments ago. Of course, it's Valentine's Day, so plenty of love in the air here in Philadelphia, Clyde. Mike Saunders, one of the all-time pros and such a big part of the Knicks' history over the years, in his 27th year as the head trainer.
Replacing my favorite guy, the late Danny Whalen. Danny big-time Whalen, the Knicks trainer, the guy that named me Clyde, gave me the moniker Clyde.
Jerome Williams. Nowhere to go.
Out of the paint.
Hardaway blocked by Dalembert.
A little confusion there by the Knicks.
Look at Dalembert dribbling the ball inside. Oh, what a move from Dalembert.
This man's 6'11", 250. He goes 80-something feet. No one denies his penetration.
Sweetney. Knicks down by 11 again. And foul called on Corliss Williamson. That'll be a second team foul.
Panasonic digital replay. Dalembert, the native of Haiti, with the block, he averages one a game. Look at the agility, the creativity right there. And the bench loves it. Iguodala especially.
Shot clock down to 5. And Jerome Williams puts it in. It's his first field goal. McKee, Iverson, Dalembert, Williamson, and Korver. Korver, quick release on the 3. Not a good shot that time, and Ariza the rebound. Knicks trying to come back again, much like they did back in December here, when they had even a bigger deficit. Feed inside, Jerome Williams, blocked by Dalembert, but a foul. And Jerome Williams will shoot 2.
Previously, Williams cannoned a 15-footer, and this time manipulating along the baseline. Hard foul by Dalembert. No malice intended. And that's sending Williams to the line. If you're going to give a foul, that's the way to do it, folks. make sure that player does not have an opportunity for a three-point play.
Williams, the spark in that game back in December, where the Knicks were down 19 with 10:51 to go, tied the biggest fourth quarter comeback in Knicks history. Game I always think of Clyde as Williams misses the second one, was the one against Milwaukee. It was back in 1972, where the team scored the last 19 points to win the game to beat the Bucks.
Was it 19 or 18? I forget.
The last 19 points. Iverson flips it up.
Yeah, that night I thought we would fall downstairs. People were stomping and yelling at the guard, man.
Marbury back to Sweetney. Still plenty of time on the shot clock.
Yeah, good moving the ball. They're going to get a good shot. They keep moving the ball.
McKee fighting over the screens. Inside Marbury. Oh, plenty of contact. Marbury still puts it in.
With the left hand, though, he had to improvise to get it over Dellenberg.
And a lead back to six for Philadelphia. Knicks hanging in there.
Iverson is silent thus far.
Silent in the second half. Iverson left open, has room, and can't hit the three. Sweetney with the rebound.
Knicks with all the momentum now. Stephon should take it and create. Make something happen.
Marbury gets in the paint again, flips it high off the glass. Beautiful ball from Marbury, and it's a four-point game. Timeout, Philadelphia.
Yeah, good perseverance by the Knicks now.
A 7-0 run, and Stephon Marbury leading the way.
Early on, the paint, the Knicks thought the paint was wet, but not now. Stephon, two consecutive hoops. This was his first foray into the paint, and the left-handed scoop, and he's got two consecutive hoops.
High school hoops fans, catch tomorrow's superstars today. Get the complete Tri-State Rundown with Mike Quick and Max Preps High School Weekly, only on MSG Network.
There's a whole new world of high-definition television to experience. And nobody takes you there like DirecTV HD. With more HD sports, more HD movies, more HD channels. With the widest variety of HD programming available, isn't it time to rethink the way you look at television? DirecTV HD.
Oh. That's number four.
Not a foul.
That's
come
number
on.
Four on.
Come on.
This stuff tastes funny.
In the net, 17 for Ray. Deep pass, turnaround jump shot. He counters with a...
With up to 40 NBA games a week, new stats and highlights, NBA League Pass from DirecTV is heaven. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS today.
Listen, this candidate follows orders.
Somebody got into our heads.
Neurons got exposed and circuits got rewired.
Your orders.
Centurion Global brainwashed you to be the first privately owned president of the United States.
Order this movie on pay-per-view now.
We can adjust character, change personality.
Academy Award winners Denzel Washington and Meryl Streep.
You swore that this was fail-safe.
Vote with your remote. Order the Manchurian Candidate now. Rated R.
.604 remaining, just at the midway point here of the fourth quarter. Knicks down 15 in the second half, have cut it to four. Jackson deep, double team, back out Williamson. Takes it out Korver. Korver open for three. Won't go, and Sweetney with a rebound.
All the shots were falling previously, not going now for the Sixers. Stephon must continue to create.
Marbury for three. It's good. Stephon Marbury from downtown, and it's a one-point game.
Iverson had his way in the first half. Stephon controlling the second half.
Another big comeback here in Philadelphia. Knicks on a 10-0 run.
They're also in a 2-3 zone right now, frustrating the Sixers.
Ball deflected. Ariza dives on it, and it's going to be a jump ball. Excellent hustle from Ariza off the deflection.
Ariza couldn't call a timeout. He was lying on his hands. And watch the 2-3 zone. Ariza is in the middle of the zone. Watch why he couldn't call a timeout. He's lying on his arms. That's why he has to have the jump ball here.
He'll go against Williamson, who's slightly bigger. Ariza can jump a little higher
and quicker. I think he'll win it. I think he'll win the tap.
A prediction from Clyde.
Carlos would not let it happen.
Korver all alone in the corner. Sixers don't see him. Iverson with a three. Won't go. Sweetney another rebound. Iverson 1 of 8 in the second half. 4 points after 31 in the first half. Jerome Williams gets inside, forces it up and puts it in. And the Knicks have their first lead since the opening quarter.
Is this deja vu all over again?
An amazing comeback here in Philly, much like they did in December. But there's still plenty of time remaining. Korver for three.
No.
And knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Ariza.
Sixers showing some anxiety now. The Knicks are unflappable as the Sixers will have it underneath.
12 straight points by the Knicks.
Jerome Willing in the paint.
Mark Jackson makes his move. Ariza still with the ball. He looked like he picked up his pivot.
Oh!
Screaming for the call. He didn't get it. And Jackson puts in the bucket. Marbury finding Hardaway. Lobs to Jerome Williams. Fake goes back up and puts it in. Jerome Williams providing the spark again.
Feasting in the paint now. Two consecutive hoops in there.
He's got 7 points. All of them. Here in the fourth quarter. And you see the Knicks shooting in the period. Williamson. And Ariza just can't guard him. He's just too big down low.
Yeah, mauling Ariza that time was Carlos. 6'7", 245.
It's a tough matchup. Knicks have a small lineup out there right now.
But it's a quick one and a very confident one right now.
Marbury puts it in. Stephon Marbury again from downtown. And a 2-point lead for the Knicks. 3:43 remaining. Marbury erupting here in this fourth quarter. Iverson comes right back with a three. And the Sixers regain the lead. Marbury kicks it out. Ariza in and out. And Iverson the rebound. Korver looking. Ball nearly stolen. Williamson inside, stripped and stolen by Sweetney.
Yep, again, don't leap in the air looking to pass.
Marbury, another three. Sweetney grabs the rebound. The good hands able to corral it with his left. Marbury penetrates. Back to Hardaway. Hardaway puts it in. Three-pointer for Penny Hardaway.
Good play is contagious. All the Knicks with the knack right now.
Iverson setting it up. Hardaway guarding him.
Oh, there's a man wide open.
And Ariza is in trouble. Marbury yelling at him to get the ball in. The rookie just looks a little confused right now defensively.
Stephon's going to get the double.
Marbury drives. Oh, offensive foul on Marbury. And we'll have a timeout. Let's look at the call. Oh, that's a tough call. He lowered the shoulder a bit. But that's his fourth foul. Tied at 102 here in the fourth.
Great job on that presentation today.
Thank you. See you tomorrow.
It's as driven as you are. The new redesigned Camry XLE. Now that's moving you forward.
To celebrate the joy of reading, the New York Knicks recently held a special event aboard the USS Intrepid. Knicks players know that spending time reading with kids in their community is a rewarding and worthwhile experience.
Fiendish friends, the Fright Night flight has reached its end.
Students will take away from this Read to Achieve event the motivation to read more, to encourage them that reading is important, reading can be fun.
So join the Knicks, open a book, and read to achieve.
What do you do when you've had the best vehicle in its class for the past 6 years? You go back to the drawing board. You make it more powerful, yet more fuel efficient. You give it enhanced safety features with run flat tires. You make it more comfortable and more ingenious than ever before. Introducing the all-new Honda Odyssey. A great idea made better.
Here in Philadelphia, 2:34 remaining in the fourth. Knicks and Sixers tied. Next up for the Knicks, Wednesday against the Bucks. We'll have the game for you on the MSG Network. Last game before the All-Star break. But this one has been exciting. Knicks down 15 in the second half, down 11 in the fourth quarter, have come back to take the lead. But the Sixers storming back as well.
And Iverson now starting to erupt. He had a big three-pointer, and then he drew the offensive foul against Stephon.
Knicks trying the big comeback. Back on December 17th here in Philly, it tied their largest fourth quarter comeback in Knicks history. Down 19 early in the fourth. They finished on a 42-17 run.
And one of the catalysts, Jerome Williams, who's having another big night again tonight.
Meanwhile, Marbury, 10 of his 32 have come here in the fourth.
Knicks in a 2-3 zone.
Iverson up to McKee. Korver's their big three-point shooter. Korver finding McKee. Williams gets out. Mark Jackson, a sweeping hook, won't go. And Sweetney with another rebound.
Sweetney's doing an excellent job in there on the defense.
He has 11 rebounds for the game and has come up big here in the fourth. Marbury looking to post up Iverson, gets in the paint, rush the shot, Korver tips it out and gets the rebound.
Oh, he loses it.
It's Nick Ball.
Korver threw it right to the Sixer bench, so the Knicks will have it there.
1:57 remaining.
Talking about butter fingers, watch this. Oops. Looking away instead of getting the ball first.
So Knicks get a new 24.
Well, you need luck. Knicks had a bounce, lucky bounce last night. That might be the break they need for this game.
Marbury wants to take Iverson off the dribble. Sweetney in the low post, 8 on the shot clock. Sweetney across the lane, puts it up. Shot gets the roll, and the Knicks regain the lead.
Yep. Continue to be the aggressors on the defense now.
Sweetney having a big game here in the fourth quarter. 7 of his 11 rebounds in the period. Korver long three, short, and Hardaway the rebound. And Marbury will walk it up with 1:20 remaining.
The pick and roll should work here. There it is.
Marbury,
he threw it to the wrong side.
Jerome Williams giving the three. Wisely doesn't take it. Stops, turns, up and under. Ball knocked away and a foul call on Korver. And Jerome Williams will shoot 2 free throws.
Korver involved in the last 3 crucial plays. He lost the ball out of bounds. He forced a 3-point shot, did Korver. And now this crucial foul right here. So, and watch this sweet man. Good manipulation in the paint. And a fortuitous roll to score.
Free throws huge right now. And Jerome Williams misses the first. The Knicks have outscored the 76ers 30-17 here in this fourth quarter. But can they finish? They've been involved in so many close games. 8-15 in games decided by 6 points or less. They've struggled down the stretch.
This is obviously the kind of game that could turn around their season. As Williams able to persevere on his second shot.
And a timeout, 20-second timeout called by Jim O'Brien. As the Knicks now lead by 3. It's their largest lead here in the fourth quarter after trailing by as many as 11.
Don't foul right now and don't give the Sixers a 3-point look. Make them force them to take a 2-point shot. Don't foul to stop the clock where they can take points off the board.
After the game, we'll get a full recap of this one, plus all the sports news. On MSG Sports Desk, presented by Toyota. The NHL on the brink of canceling the season. News from Derek Jeter. And Wrestling with Pride. I don't know what that's about. Oh, it's a story about wrestling at Hofstra. Very inspirational story, I'm told, by producer Spencer Julian. So stay tuned.
Pride is very apropos right now. We mentioned that at the start of the third quarter, the Knicks would have to show some pride and fortitude, and they have. Uphill struggle all evening, but now they have the lead. Now they must maintain it.
Another game going down to the final minute. Perhaps another game going down to the final possession. Knicks have played their share of them this year. Tied for the league lead. Iverson almost got up. That should have been a trap. If you're not allowed to get up. Korver kicks it inside to Williamson, and Williamson lays it in.
Good thing Sweetney didn't foul there. So many times we've seen the Knicks create that foul for the 3-point opportunity. So a good job by Sweetney staying away.
Bob Delaney telling Herb Williams, yes, you can get up. I don't think you're allowed to get up after you fall down. Barber puts it up. Shot won't go, and Carver the rebound. Knicks clinging to a one-point lead. Iverson kicks it out to McKee. McKee back to Iverson. Double team. Lost the ball out of bounds. Excellent double team by Jerome Williams and Marbury.
And that's how you use the sideline as an extra man. Iverson right on the sideline. The double team, nowhere to go. So watch this good play by the Knicks. Watch Iverson defends himself, sees the sideline. He can't go there. And can't elude the two Knicks who are smothering him.
And that's Iverson's eighth turnover. He had a 9 turnover a game earlier. And Herb Williams calls time. 27.7 remaining. Knicks with the ball and a one-point lead.
I'm no car expert,
but I do know what I want.
You know what I want?
More bang.
More bang for my buck.
From a car and
a car company.
That's why I got a Forenza.
By Suzuki.
Suzuki!
Protected by America's number one warranty.
Numero uno.
It's got more room and more features
than Civic.
Forenza.
It gives so much.
And it asks so little. Who says you can't have it all?
Forenza!
Forenza!
Buy the Forenza sedan for just $129 a month for 48 months during our Smart Start event.
With IO Digital Cable Service, you can order on-demand movies instantly with the push of a button. Throughout time, men have waged war, some for power, some for glory, some for honor, and some for love. Watch the epic drama Troy, starring Brad Pitt and Orlando Bloom. Order hit movies now on demand on IO Channel 500.
I really can't stay.
Baby, it's cold outside.
I've got to go away.
Baby, it's cold out there.
This evening has been
hoping that you
so
drop
very
in.
Nice.
I'll take your hands, they're cold as ice.
I ought to say no, no, no,
I'm
sir. At least I'm gonna say that I tried.
Lots of Santa hurt in my pride.
I really can't stay.
Baby, don't hold out.
Oh, but it's cold.
27.7 seconds remaining, fourth quarter in Philly. Knicks leading by one. Shot clock's at 24, so there's a 3.7 difference. This is where the Knicks at times have struggled this year. Fourth quarter execution. You see the Knicks with one timeout remaining. And they have that foul to give. Dangerous pass into the hands of Marbury.
And this is why they're where they are, because of this man's offensive prowess.
Herb Williams and Marbury both wanted a foul there on Iverson. Marbury has to be careful leaning in. Shot clock down to 10. Marbury holding it. Shot clock at 6. Nearly knocked away. Marbury puts it up. Shot is up. Won't go. Corbin the rebound and a timeout with 3.5 remaining. Iverson comes up hobbling after fighting for a screen.
Iverson was trying to draw the pick foul on Kurt Thomas and he flopped on the court. There's nothing there to absorb the shock.
The Sixers wanted a foul called, but they'll have the ball.
Watch the flop by Iverson. That could have been a foul right there. Hacking at the ball. Watch Kurt Thomas come up in your screen on the right side.
Just holding, waiting for the shot clock to wind down.
Oh.
Thomas was, it looked like he was still. Iverson just tripped on him.
Right, and he fell right on his hip.
Now the Sixers will get the ball in their front court with 3.5 remaining. Key here is the Knicks have a foul to give. So what they should do when the Sixers inbound it is maybe try and let a second or two go off and then foul. You just have to be careful not to foul in the act of shooting. But the foul to give can help the Knicks here. And Philadelphia still with timeouts.
The Knicks have been hurt by Mark Jackson and Williamson on the interior, so they can't forget about those guys while they focus on Iverson.
Sixers still with one full timeout remaining. As once again, and it's happened so many times this season, the game going down to the final possession.
And don't foul, whatever they do. Don't foul.
Marbury, Hardaway, Thomas, Sweetney, and Ariza come out on the floor for the Knicks. Corver, McKee, Williamson, Jackson, and Iverson. Obviously, Philly would like to get the ball into Iverson's hand, but always here on this play, watch the man who inbounds the ball. Frequently, he inbounds, and they go back to him. Now they put 4 seconds on the clock. They've added 5/10. Iverson gets it in the corner, tied up, feeds to Jackson, Jackson banks it in, and the Knicks call time with 6/10 of a second remaining as Philly takes the lead.
As we mentioned, those guys have been very effective in the paint. You can't put all your focus on Iverson. And the Knicks did. They double him in the corner. Jackson rolled down the paint for the hoop.
So now the Knicks use the timeout. Let's watch.
There's the double. And Jackson rolling down the paint. Kurt Thomas, a belated attempt to deny him.
A great pass from Iverson out of the double team.
If you're going to double, don't give him an opening to look inside like they did there. Got to take that away. That's why you're doubling. See, if you're going to double, take away this interior pass. Make him pass on the perimeter. You can't give him a direct interior pass.
And you saw how the ball took a little while to go through the rim. If it went in straight through, the Knicks would have more time left. They might put more time on. I'm not sure. Yep, they're going to make it 1 second left. Now, that's certainly enough time to catch and shoot, and the Knicks will have the ball in the front court. But they are out of timeouts, and the Sixers do not have a foul to give. So it's now the Knicks' chance for a final shot. Of course, last night, the Knicks won. And the final seconds as Tim Thomas hit that wild circus shot, hit off the rim, off the backboard, and went through at the buzzer. Can they win at the buzzer once again? This was last night at the Garden against the Bobcats in the final seconds. Obviously, a lot less time. Lot less time tonight. Thomas on the bench. 1 second remaining. Muhammad, Crawford, Thomas, and Marbury. Penny Hardaway will inbound the ball. D'Alembert up on the inbounds pass to try and distract. Smart move from Jim O'Brien.
Muhammad rolling to the back.
Puts it up. No good. Just off the rim. The play worked beautifully. And Muhammad just didn't seem to get his balance. And a gut-wrenching loss for the Knicks tonight in Philly.
And you have to think the groin injury of Muhammad, he did not have the elevation. The play was there. He was there but could not finish.
It looked like a smart play play as the Sixers seemed to be focusing on Marbury. And instead, Crawford goes back. They got the pass to him, and he just couldn't get it up over the rim.
Oh, it opens up just like they wanted. See right there. There he is. He's open. But could not get the extension that he needed to put it in.
Marbury set a terrific pick on Muhammad's man. Watch here.
The pass was a little awry, but still, if he had his leaping ability, he could have funneled it into the hoop.
And what a difficult loss for the Knicks after a terrific comeback. Down 15 in the second half and came back. And actually took the lead, but then unable to make the play in the final seconds. And the Knicks lose to the 76ers by a point here in Philadelphia. So a tough, tough loss for the Knicks tonight. A superb second half. And they wind up going down to defeat and fall now to 20-32 on the season. Time for our Bud play of the game. And of course, the key one here.
The question here, Mike, is the Knicks had a foul to give. So they had ample time to foul Iverson. They had a foul to give and did not use it. Right here, foul him.
Right. That's where they should have fouled.
They should have fouled.
Absolutely.
Folks. They had that foul to give.
They would have then had to inbound again. The play of the game brought to you by Budweiser. Grab a cold, fresh Budweiser. It's game time, but they did not use the foul to give. Jackson put it in for the bucket, and the Knicks had a good shot in the final second, but couldn't put it down. And this is a tough, tough loss. Sixers win it 106-105. We'll be back after this timeout.